drive is in a small little track.
Yeah.
All is fair in love and war, right? And racing war, so.
Oh!
Getting a little western, getting sideways. Coming in hot. He is definitely on the gas on that XG750. These guys are all having some fun out here.
Welcome everyone to Flat Out Friday live here in the Bradley Center, downtown Milwaukee, Wisconsin. I'm Scotty Dubler, and I'm joined by X Games gold medalist Lance Corey. Tonight we're seeing some great flat track racing on a 1/16th mile oval right here on some concrete. Lance, what are you looking forward to the most?
Really, what I'm looking forward to the most is the Boon e-bikes. Those are the ones I want to ride.
Yeah, I would like to ride any of those bikes out there. Man, it looks like they're all having a lot of fun. We started earlier in the afternoon, and we're just getting faster and faster as we go.
That's right. It's amazing how much power these guys can put to the ground in such a small track on polished concrete.
Well, you throw a little bit of Dr. Pepper syrup on there, it makes it nice and sticky, and they go extra fast.
Yep, that's right. You can actually smell the syrup all the way up here.
Well, we're getting ready for an exciting night of racing. Let's go down trackside for our sidekick, and she'll tell us about the first race.
I am Diana Dahlgren. I'm down here on the racetrack giving you the fun interviews, the nitty-gritty, what you guys need to know. And what we have first up is the Grom class. These are going to be your stock Honda Groms or your Kawasaki Z125 Pros only. And you want to know something? They've removed the kickstand, turn signals, the license plate displays, mirrors, and rear foot pegs. We've got a lot of racing happening, but like you said, we got that Dr. Pepper syrup. It's been applied with the sprayer all day today, giving these racers the traction they need to get around these corners. Guys, it's going to be a good night of racing.
It sure is, Diane. We can't wait to get the Grom race going. Like we said, Lance, we had 260 entries. We started earlier today. Here comes the semifinal for the Groms. There are three riders in this one, and the fast winner, the only winner, I guess, will move on to the final. They're going to come out every time, Lance, and get one lap to warm up their tires, maybe, you know, knock the dirt off their tires, and then they'll line up. We're going to go racing.
Yeah, no, that makes sense. Make sure the bike's warm and ready and the tires are warm and ready, and may the best man win.
So in the Grom class, we started with 18 riders, and we'll work our way down. We'll have one main event a little bit later on. This is semifinal number one. Number 79 out there is Storlino. They gave us all the hardest names in this first race.
They
number
did.
Five is Malikowski, and the 45 is Topsikowski. So here we go already. Light turns green, and they are off into the first corner. It's Grom side by side down the back straightaway. There's three of them out there. We're only taking the winner, Lance.
I don't know. I mean, 45 looks like he's off to a good start, and the two in the back look like they're going to be fighting each other for a little bit.
Well, you don't want to fight for last. You want to get out there and go for the win. Is there's a good shot from up above. There's a lot of rubber down there on top of that Dr. Pepper syrup. And this is semifinal number one for the Grom class, winner only. There's the 45 pulling away.
There he goes. Now, what do you think? You think that one dude out there has a brake light on his bike. Do you think that's an advantage or disadvantage?
Man, I don't know. Maybe it's a distraction, so it could be an advantage, but maybe you know when that guy's getting on the brake, so that might not be a factor. I don't know. White flag's out from Kevin Clark. He's the flagman to the stars, they call him. His last lap for number 45. Topsikowski out there on this Grom, and there is the checkered flag bouncing off
Whoa.
The wall. Woo! And that's how we get the show started right there. That's semi-final number one for the Groms. Up next, semi-final number two for the Groms. And there's a lot of stuff happening. They're tuning in on Facebook all around the world. We're expecting a large crowd, and you're going to give us some people that are tuning
yeah.
in to Facebook a little
yeah,
bit later on. So if you want to hit us up on the Harley-Davidson Facebook page, maybe we'll read some comments a little bit later on. Tell us what you think. Pick your favorite rider and just let us know what's happening out there. So Lance will bring that to us here in a little bit. This is Grom semi number two. The 444 is Campbell, 34 is Eiding, and the 113 is Rasmussen. And they're out there on the Groms, and one of them's on the Kawasaki Z125. So that's the little Kawasaki one. Again, winner, just like the last one, the winner out of this one moves on directly to the main event. So when they bring you out, Lance, you have to go to the inside to the outside. So the pole sitter can either pick inside or outside, and they all have to follow suit.
Well, I would personally want inside. You
Absolutely.
Know, that's the shortest line in the race.
Absolutely. That's a good pick right there. You're showing your racing skills. You know, I know he's a freestyle motocrosser, but you're also a racer before that.
I am a racer, born and raised basically since I was born. 4 years old, I started racing, and that's what I know.
All right. 444 out in front. That is Campbell. Campbell leading the way on his red motorcycle. That's a little Grom out there. Takes a look over his shoulder. Most times when you're racing, you don't want to do that, but he's got a pretty big advantage already early on in this one.
Yeah, it looks like he's just taking off on this class, and pretty sure he's going to take it home unless he I guess he's the only man that can beat himself right now.
Yeah, if he falls off or something like that, then that would be it. So he needs to keep it on two wheels. Kevin Clark shows him two laps to go. He'll be signaling the riders all night long for you new fans out there, you new flat track fans. And that time by, he showed him two laps with the white and the green standing sideways. White flag, that means not to surrender, but it means one more lap to go here in this semifinal. Smooth sailing for the leader. He is way out in front.
I hear some loud bikes starting up right now.
Absolutely. So the 444 taking the win, Campbell, and he will move on into the main event. Man, that was quick, fast, and in a hurry. We're already moving on into our amateur semifinal. And let's go to down. Diana's out there on the racetrack. Are you crazy, girl?
Yeah, that's right. I am on the racetrack. The camera's not pointing towards me, but I'm here. And we are having the Open AM class right now. These participants, they're 12 years or older. They must be 14 years old to ride the 450 CE. No brakeless bikes are allowed. And these bikes must be full framed with the 150 minimum CCs. Let's check them out, guys.
Open amateur, the biggest class, 42 entries here today. Number 95 is Mock. The 75 is Ellis, 911 Clements, 351 is Medema, 713 Wegenstadt, and 73 Smith, and the 558 is Warden. So a big group right here. I got top zero to the main event, so I'm not sure who all's gonna go.
Yeah.
Looks like that's what that says, so. All we know is we got to run up front, try to get there in a hurry, and then we'll take the fastest guys moving on into the main event. Open amateurs coming up. And there's a bunch of them out there, so it's go or go home time.
Now, what's interesting is I see dirt bikes, and then I see Harley Davidsons.
Well, you can ride whatever you want. Open amateur class. You know, Diana just explained the rules. There's another big bike with Ukes on the side of it, and you can see a bunch of bright orange shirts up here in the crowd. They're all from Ukes Harley Davidson.
Don't you have a story for me of the yellow bike in the back?
The yellow bike, that is, well, not that one.
Oh, not that one.
Well, nope, there's another one coming out. But no, that is Bree. Bree actually used to have a road race team. She's back in the pack right now. This is her first ever race, and she's out here with these guys. 911 on the inside, taking over the lead. Red flag is out.
Someone jumped the gate out there.
You noticed? So?
Yeah, something happened.
All right. So there's not a starting gate like motocross, so they line them up. There's a laser beam going across the starting line. So if anybody creeps across the line, they know that, and they'll signal somebody. So they're going to probably put somebody in the back row. 911 pulls up that Harley Davidson. It looks like an XG750 to me.
It is. It's a pretty rad-looking XG750.
Dude, there are bikes all the way around through all the aisles and the walkways underneath this building, completely full of motorcycles.
Wow.
So it doesn't look like they slid anybody back. Maybe they just weren't quite ready to start the race. So we'll take off right now. Bike turns green. The XG out in front, got a Steve Merchant jersey on right there. 9-11, your leader, Clements. Three semifinals in this class. Amateur semifinal number one on the track. 7-13 right there on the back tire. Some more hard names up here up north. 9-11 goes a little bit wide. Here comes a 7-13 looking at the inside. Saw another brake light like you were talking about earlier.
Yeah, is that affecting him out there?
I don't know, man. I don't remember racing anybody with the brake light, so I don't know how that would bother you.
Now we have a 750cc against a 450cc.
Yeah.
I see them both putting power to the ground. Do you think there's an advantage on that?
Well, the 450 is a lot lighter weight, I would assume. But as long as you get that traction, you know, you slide your rear with, you know, your butt over that rear wheel, get some traction, and take them off the corner. That's what you got to be doing. So it seems to be working for both of them. White flag is out for the 911. Clements on the Harley Davidson. Last lap, the lap times are so fast, it's hard to keep track of. Checkered flag is out. It's 9-11 with the win. Looks like 7-13 finishes up there in second. That is Wegenstadt on a Yamaha.
That was a close one. Clements had to stay on his game the whole race.
Yeah, he did. He was right there, which was good. They didn't tell us exactly how many people are transferring to the main event, so we'll see the fastest out of that class in the main. Up next, amateur semifinal number 2 of 3. So there's 3 semifinals in this class. Here they come. 240's going to lead them out. That's Wick. We got 976 Perriman. Permanian. 77 is Rochelot. 38L is Jones. 18 Frank. 37 Doenbaugh. And 08 is Martin. So here they come again. Same class. Open amateur class.
Now I see Jeff Wick out there has a GoPro facing backwards. Is that him thinking he's going to be in the lead and wants to film everyone behind him?
I would assume so. Yeah, maybe he's got, maybe his buddy started back on the back row. You think?
I don't know.
I don't know. I'd face it forward, but maybe he started watching what's happening in front of him. He'd already seen that.
Uh-oh, he stalled out right now.
Oh, so you're talking about the 240 with the GoPro strapped to his back, right?
Yep.
Yep. So once again, looks like we got an old style Honda right there near the outside. That's a good looking framer. The rest are motocross style bikes. Here we go. Shields are up. It don't matter. We're going green.
Oh, he stalled. Jeff Wick stalled in the launch.
Bumping
another stall. Two stalls in the first corner.
There's bikes all over the place. Only three of them. Now four of them are still running. Tough break for the 38L. That's Jones out there. There's the 08 of Martins. Martins with some pretty cool looking pink gear.
And the number 08, you guys, this is a 15-year-old girl riding down here, and look at her go. I mean, she's on the big screen right now.
That is right. 08 is out there. That's Zaria Martin. She was the winner here last year in the ladies' class, so Zaria knows her way around the track for sure. She looked good in that pink fly gear. That's Fox, isn't it? It's Fox gear.
Yep.
She's already lapping people, man. That's cool.
I mean, she's staying smooth is really what it is. Her throttle control is just perfect. You notice a lot of the other guys are kind of sliding out, not getting the traction down.
Absolutely. Two laps to go from Kevin Clark. He shows them two laps remaining. The leader's caught up to some lap traffic, and that's allowed second place to close the gap. That's the 37 bike of Doenbach. And Doenbach's looking up the inside. Battle for the lead.
Uh-oh.
They touch tires. Yep. Checkered flag is out. The crowd is going crazy. As a young lady, Zaria takes the win. She's from Fond du Lac, Wisconsin, right there. Zaria Martin's taking the win on the 08 machine. We'll see her later on in that main event. Up next, semifinal, number 3 of 3 in the amateur class. 84 is going to be Winkler. As a look at the restart of the first corner, one bike stalled right there, one stalled off the line.
Yep.
Yeah, man. That's tough. You don't want to stall your bike because the track is so fast. If you stall it, there's hardly any way you're going to catch back up.
Yep.
He's semifinal number 3, the open amateur class. 84 is Winkler. 06, Laurel Prack. 74 is Cromie. 59 is Barry. That's Bob Barry. If you guys are flat track fans, that's his nephew out there. The 11 is Hubbard. Annie Wyman, another female out there on the 158. And Noyes on the number 14 bike. Mitchell Noyes on the Honda from Milwaukee, sponsored by The Shop, as they pull up to the line. Keep your eyes on 74 out there. That's Cromie. That's Brooke. That's another female rider out there. So we got some girls in the open amateur class. We also have a ladies class a little bit later on. Lance, there's 11 classes running here tonight.
That's incredible. Do you think that these girls are actually going to be racing the women's class as well?
I would assume so, yeah. You know, this is a good chance to get warmed up, see where they stack up against the guys, and then they'll go up there and battle against the ladies. The 14 bike having an issue out there.
Now, notice, that's a two-stroke, and that suspension's full height.
Way up there. That looks like one of your bikes.
Yeah, right?
All right, so tough break for the 14 bike. I didn't have them on the list. The 74 gets a terrible start. So she might have done that on purpose to see where these guys are going to race. It's Prack on the inside. Laurel Prack, actually, I saw him a few years back at the Dirt Track Grand Championships. He brought me one of his t-shirts and a bottle of water. He goes, dude, you've been announcing all day and you said my name right every time. I thought that was awesome.
That's something that I've dealt with a lot in my career. People call me Curry.
Yeah.
They don't know how to pronounce it, so.
Yeah, I get it. My last name's Dubler and everybody doesn't know how to say it right either. So I get it. So I try to say everybody's name right when I'm announcing for sure. Laurel Prack out front, 06, showing the way.
He's looking solid, elbows up.
Uh-oh, 59 shoves it in there.
Oh, look at him shaking his head like, what are you doing?
Yeah, what are you doing to me? That's Barry out there sliding up the inside. Blake Barry from North Prairie,
uh-oh.
Wisconsin.
Whoa!
Two laps to go. We got a barn burner out there. Prack goes back to the lead. Here comes Barry. Will we repay the favor? Whoa!
Barry isn't scared to touch tires.
He'll stick that front wheel in there. He's showing you what he's got. Oh! Whew. Barry just about came off the motorcycle. Checkered flag is out.
Look at him shaking his head like,
I got this. I got it. Yeah, he's not even looking back. He's pumped up. Look at that. He's pumped up. I love it. This kid's going at it. Good racing so far. Here's a look at some of the replay action. There is the 11 bike with Barry going the outside. Laurel Prack went up the inside.
That's a clean pass.
Nice and smooth pass right there. Man, it's been awesome so far. We're just getting started.
Rubbing is racing.
Absolutely, for sure. Let's go trackside once again. Diana Dahlgren, check it out.
So next up, we have the Open Vintage class. These engine sizes are unlimited. These racers must be 18 years old today. If they aren't, they can't race here. Then we have the engines. They must be 1981 or older. That's almost a full decade older than me, guys. And not only that, the rear brakes are mandatory. Check them out.
You're just trying to tell us how young you are? Is that what you're doing, Diane?
Yes, I am.
Okay,
I got it.
So, man, the vintage bikes are out there. You can definitely hear the different sound of the motorcycles. I hear four strokes out there. So this
you can smell the two-stroke, too.
All right, vintage semi-final number one. Top two will go to the main event. Number 90 is Peterson on a Honda. 50 Skipworth. 431 is Darren Carter out there in a Bull Taco. 237 is Moldenhauer. 43 is Reese. 51 is DeBoer. 18 Hanum out there on the Honda. So this is Open Vintage. Check out, there's some big heavy machine right there. Closest to it, that 90 bike, that's one of the big Hondas. Bull Taco right in the middle. Top two to the main event. Vintage semifinal. 237 up the inside. Holdenbauer got the lead. Now the Bull Taco goes to the front. That's Darren Carter. I used to race against him quite a bit.
Aren't you number 43 too?
I used to be national number 43, that's correct.
So, and I know you got a thing for Bull Tacos.
Yeah, so he's making it look good. My grandfather and my dad raced a lot of Bull Tacos when I was growing up. So it's cool to see the 43 out in front, and it's on a Bull Taco.
Where are Bull Tacos made again?
Made in Spain.
Made back, in Spain.
Back in the day.
The
yep.
craziest thing is I'm reading these comments of people from around the world.
Yep.
I'm reading people proud of the Bull Taco. I'm reading of people that are in Spain watching this.
Awesome.
I'm reading people all over. Dave Barrett in Australia. People all over America. Monty Lathan checking out all the racing.
Awesome.
Lance, why don't you go ahead and read some of that Filipino language I see coming through. We got Chinese. We got Philippines.
Yeah, it's pretty hard. I can't do it. I don't have time. They're coming in too fast.
So they're getting kind of spread out right now. Looks like the 43 still way out in front. He's actually on cruise control. He's so out in front, Lance. He's just barely putzing around. Maybe he's saving that Bull Taco for the main event.
Yeah, I mean, he knows he made it, and he is saving all that energy.
Yeah, that too, and the motorcycle. You know, those bikes are old. The Bull Tacos were made back in the early 70s. And that's a beautiful looking Bull Taco Astro right there, the 43, or it's 431. They added a one on it. So that's 431, vintage semi, final number one.
I do want to chime in. I saw some people asking here, as the Harley Hooligan raced yet? They haven't raced yet, and they're coming up, and there's a lot of it.
That's true. Here's your look at the wheelie across the start-finish line. Darren Carter, 431. The flagman gets right there in the action. That is Kevin Clark. That's what he's known for. He'll do it on a mile, on a half mile, and on a 1/16th. Concrete oval. Kevin Clark, man, he's out there. Vintage semi number two coming to the track. The zero is Saunders. The 11 is Jungroth. 37, Doenbach. 40 is Brosh. 618, Zielinski. 8 is Castle. 18M is Marino. It's another group of vintage bikes. The 40 bike, I see him a lot. That's an old style looking, looks like an old KX out there. Did you see that bike in the pits?
Yeah, I saw that bike in the pits. I looked at all these bikes in the pits, and some of them are so clean, so nice, I can't even believe that they're out there banging bars on them.
So, which one do you want to ride the most?
I mean, that Bull Taco that just won the race was pretty pristine, I'm going to be honest.
You got a shift on the wrong side. You think you can handle that?
I noticed his shifter and brake were both on the right side.
That was the secret. That was part of the key why they were so fast back in the day, because you could actually shift the motorcycle, which was good if you're on a bigger track. You know, here, you pretty much put it in one gear and leave it. But when you're on a bigger track, those Bull Tacos, you had to shift them. The shifter was already on the right side, so it worked out perfect. Light turns green. 11 grabs the hole shot. The crowd makes a lot of noise here. We're expecting a full crowd here tonight, Lance.
No, it's incredible.
So the 11 bike is out in front. That's Jungroth. Top two going to the main event. Here comes the 37 going all the way around the outside. That's Doenbach. Doenbach's looking for a way around the outside. He's got a tinted shield on. It must be really bright out there for him. Leader has his shield lifted up.
That's right.
Oh, 57 goes wide. There's a good battle for second place going on. The 40 bike's catching up. That's the transfer spot.
How many are they taking from here?
They're taking two riders, so the battle's going to be for a second position. 37 caught the leader again.
Uh-oh.
Now there's the 40 bike. He's in the mix, ladies and gentlemen.
Whoa!
Whoa, watch out. Watch out, cameraman.
Bike going sideways on the track.
Man, right in front of the leaders. It's the 11 bike out in front. That's Jungreth.
But number 40, he's trying to get in there. He wants to transfer. He doesn't want to go home tonight.
Oh, the leader slips wide as the white flag comes out. New leaders, the 37. Doenbach goes to the lead. Looks like he's got some old-style leathers on out. Oh, 40 bike throws it away. Checkered flag is out. So the transfer is the 37 and the 11. Tough break for my buddy, number 40.
Like Ricky Bobby says, if you ain't first, you're last.
That's right. That means you're putting it in the hall or you'll be done for the night. So there goes that Kawasaki. He's got day glow, yellow frame, and a bright green gas tank. Let's take a look at the replay here from Flat Out Friday. 40 goes up the inside. It was a last ditch effort. Oh. Just throws it away.
Man. He leaned into that thing. He gave it all, but he tried to use his buddy as a berm, I think.
Well, you got to do what you got to do. We got another interesting class coming up next. Let's go down trackside to Diana Dahlgren.
Yep, that's right, Scotty. We have the Boonie bike class coming up next. These bikes are pull start, no larger than 12-inch wheels, rigid rear wheel. The left foot peg is foldable or removed. Remember that these riders must wear full AMA required racing safety gear, including gloves, long sleeve shirt, and ankle high boots. They must have full faced helmets. Riders must be 18 years old. Guys, take it away.
Man, this looks like a lot of fun. I think we should ride this class next year.
This is the class that I want to be out there on.
Well, it's the Boonie class, so you just heard the rules. We're not sure how many transfer to the main event. We'll see when we get there. But the 62 is Seiler, 64 is Schneider, 44 is Chernowski, 94 is Hansen, 25 is Spence. Lindkowski's on the 7 bike. McManus, 17. 53 is Fester. DeBoer, 5'11". Rasmussen, 113. Von Muntz, 33.3. And the 418 is Barney. So there's a whole lot of them out there. And this is the Boonie class. There's 29 total. So we'll narrow it down to probably the top 12 for the main event. We had heat races earlier this afternoon before we came live here on Facebook.
Now, why are they lining up? One guy's in the back lineup, one guy's in the front. How's that fair?
Well, and just speaking from my experience, they didn't say anything about that in the riders' meeting, but the rider that picked the second row, he either was supposed to line up there or he was supposed to line up further on the outside. Instead of taking the outside lineup, he said, nope, I'm going to line up on the inside of row number two. So it's kind of a smart move, but it's kind of, you're putting yourself so much further behind everybody else. It's a gutsy move.
It is a gutsy move, but what you said there, being on the outside, you're pushed wide. I'd almost rather let them go wide, come in, and at least be in front of the mid-pack.
But then you're going to hope that the riders in the second row haven't caught up to you by that point. So it's a gutsy move. So I've seen it done on the Grand National Circuit, too, you know, the American Flat Track Tour. Some riders will say, hey, I don't want to start on the outside. I'll start back row inside.
Is this at the pro level right here?
For Milwaukee, maybe, and Flat Out Friday. The Boonie class semifinal. Look at the leader shot out of there like he's out of a can. Oh, we got two of them down on the back straightaway. The leader is gone. Check it out.
Uh-oh, already into the wall.
Oh, you got to pull the bike started. I can't even see the number on the leader. Here they come back around. I think that's the 25 bike.
It is.
25 bike is Spence out there in the Boonie class. Spence showing the way. You think you'd have a chance in this class, Lance?
I know I'd be smiling in this class.
Unless somebody runs over your foot.
I'll be out there in some boots.
Well, you're supposed to wear ankle top boots, like they said in the rules. Looks like he's got some tinfoil wrapped around his boot, but some riders wear a steel shoe and then they'll put carpet on the bottom. Some riders wear a steel shoe and put duct tape. And some riders just go out there in their boots and just don't put anything. I think that's some tinfoil.
He's staying out there in the lead, number 25.
He's pretty far out there. That is Spence out there. I'm trying to find some more information on him on our list over here.
Lapping people already.
Did you tell him that's the fast way around the track?
I told him some of my secrets that I saw.
All right, go fast, turn left. White flag's out in a hurry. 25 way out in front. He just looks like he's out there in cruise control, maybe setting himself up for the main event. He got some lap traffic, and there's the checkered flag. So tough break for the 17 bike who finished one lap down. That was McManus. Looks like he's having fun. Doesn't even need no goggles. He knew he's going to be out in the front.
Yep.
Open up the gate.
Now, I wonder how many of these guys are actually going to be racing big bikes as well.
Probably quite a few of them. I mean, if you're going to make the trip, you might as well run two classes, you know. This rider stops over here to do a little burnout for the
fans.
There
we go. I see that smoke. Thing wheelied on him. Power.
Absolutely. Cleared off. Let's go down trackside and hear from Diane.
Scotty, Lance, these guys must have 19-inch AMA-approved dirt track tires. There's no slicks allowed here. Must have a license from a national governing body. These guys are the best in flat track. The pro class is going down.
That's right. So we had heat races earlier. These are the semifinals. We'll take the top two to the main event. These are the guys that I get to call week in and week out. On the pole, number 88 is the Rocket Ron Wood. 22, the son of an almond farmer. That's James Monaco from California. 57, Parker Lang. 25, Kevin Anderson from Minnesota. Myers on the 199. Kenny Dahlin, number 64. And Andrew Hook from Minnesota right there on the 197, a second-generation racer. His dad was former number 77, Peter Hook. Here we go. Light turns green, and they are off. Ron Wood gets the whole shot from the inside. Two riders going to the main event. This is go time right now. Oh, run rider down.
It's incredible to see how much the pace is up for these guys and how fast they can go around this little track.
What I also notice, how close together they are.
Yep.
They are nose to tail through these corners. The 22, James Monaco, that's his brand new national number, and he is riding today for Mac Daddy Racing, George Mack out of Illinois.
I know he probably wants to get in front.
That's all right. Second, we'll put him in the main event. He came here from California, so he came just as far as you did, just to race out here flat out Friday.
That's right. But he had to bring his motorcycle.
Well, his motorcycle came up from Illinois, so he flew in here just like you. Yep, absolutely. Ron Wood right there, used to be national number 88. He's retired. He said, I'm going to Daytona to help my son race his 65cc, but before that, I'm going to come play out here in Milwaukee.
That's awesome.
Pro semi number one, top two to the main event, Ron Wood and James Monaco. Here they come, final corner. It's going to be the Rocket, Ron Wood. And Monaco comes in second, so 88 and the 22, some double digits right there, first and second place. Ron Wood taking the win on the 88 Honda. They were all Hondas in that one. We'll take a look at a replay right here, see if we can see early on in this one. Watch the left side of the screen, Kenny Dahl in the 199.
He just got pushed out.
Yeah, well, you know, if you don't have the preferred line, or if you have the preferred line, somebody else wants it, they're going to go for it. Semi-final number two, just like the last one, top two to the main event. 29K is Kyle Weiss, 161 Hurricane, Matthew Gunther, 48 Colt Feeley, 49 Nick Weimer, 196 Alec Muth, 10L Mac McGrew, and the 28P is Michael Bickerton. So one Yamaha, the restaurant Honda's in this one, and it is just like the last one. Top two will go to the main event. In the Expert Pro class, there's actually 24 entries. Only 12 of them make the main event, and that will be the 35-lap Charlotte Canes Memorial main event, where it pays $100 to lead every lap, Lance.
Every lap, you get $100 for your lead?
Yeah, let's sign up.
That's a pretty good
gig
right there.
Well, they do that to honor Charlotte Kane. She used to be she was number 35L. So they threw it. They've gathered sponsors. People donate. And extra $100 to leading the lap. That's the main event. This is semifinal number two. Hurricane Matthew Gunther grabs the whole shot. Wise up the inside. Number 29K takes over second. It's Matthew Gunther out in front trying to look forward. Look how far he turns his head to the left, like right there. He's already looking towards the straightaway.
Yeah, he was already looking at the next corner almost.
Yeah, yeah. They teach you that in some of these flat track schools.
Watch his head.
Oh, 196 on the ground.
Go down.
Right in front of the leaders. It's still Gunther out front. Here comes the 29 bike catching up. He's catching in a hurry. Eight lap semifinal. Weiss goes up the inside. New leader, 29K. Kyle Weiss from up here in Wisconsin. He was our pole setter. Gunther loses another position. The 48 goes by. It's Cole Feely. Feely doing it for Vanilla Cycles out there. Feely moves into second. Gunther now in third. Two laps to go. You see how low the air pressure is on those rear tires. You want to hook up the tire to the concrete and that Dr. Pepper syrup. Gunther tries the inside once again. Watch the battle for second place. Gunther shoves him up the track, and Gunther takes that second spot back away. That's some racing right there.
That is racing. God, you got to be so bummed if you got pushed out last corner, last lap.
I would be too, but man, how about for Hurricane Matthew Gunther not giving up? Check out the replay. Here we go. This is early on when we had the crash. The 196 got in there. Oh, in the little high side. Mac McGrew had nowhere to go. Yep. And here is the pass we saw just a few moments ago. Gunther goes, slips a little bit wide. Weiss says, thank you very much. I'll take it from here. I'll see you in the main event. Gunther, though, with a last lap pass to put it into the main event. He actually slipped back to the third spot. There's how he went to third right there. All right. Let's go down to Diana so to explain our next class.
Is the hooligan class. These riders must be 18 years or older. Modern bikes, guys, we're talking about 1986 or newer on stock framed twins. We have 750cc minimum, no dirt bikes, and no pros.
No pros. That's a new rule this year. You cannot be a professional license holder to race in this class. 17 is Fisher on the Harley-Davidson. Actually, this entire field in this race are all Harley-Davidsons. 46 is Aaron Gardado. 38's Rydell. Arciero is on the 33. Wiggins, 22X. 51, Holstein. 21's Hogan. Belinsky on the 11. Haupt on the 67. Osterman Jr. on the 37 bike. Top two to the main event. You know some of these guys out there, don't you, Lance?
I do know some of these guys. I was just on the SMC Co. Street rod that was out at X Games, and we were ripping up and down the mountain next to the half pipe. It was pretty incredible.
That was nuts, man. Those guys are crazy. All right, lining them up. They're all Harley Davidson's listed on here. That one actually looks like a complete custom gas tank, like maybe a Buell style
gas tank.
That's
off of Buell, yes, that's right.
Yeah, exactly.
All that's right. Juan out of Long Beach. He actually flew a red eye to get here from his full time job last night.
All right. Lining them up. A lot of.
One thing I want to know is a lot of these Harley hooligans are on social media. I want to know who's on social media watching us right now. I want them to post it. Hashtag Harley hooligan. I'm going to go on Instagram. I'm going to go on Facebook. I'm going to go on all the social media platforms, and I'm going to see what we got. Comment. I'm going to like. I'm going to check it out.
Hit us up on the Harley Davidson Facebook page. That's the one we're looking at. Some of the bikes took off early. Some of the bikes are still sitting in the back. I don't know what happened there. Maybe they're giving them one lap. I don't know. Looked like maybe a false start. I don't know. So there's the reason we have four semifinals in this one. There were 54 hooligans signed up. 54 hooligans. Here's a look at it. So they're going to give them one lap to check out the track. Some riders took off. Some riders said, I don't know. Maybe not. So maybe some guys weren't paying attention. There's a good shot from up above the finish line right here. Again, 54 entries here in the hooligan class. That is why we have four semifinals. We're going to take the fastest two, the top two riders out of the semifinal. Look at that. His tank says XL1000R Harley Davidson. Kind of looks like an XR750 tank, but it says XL1000R. There's one of the Gordados, the 46 machine. I see West Bend Harley Davidson on the 17 gas tank. All right, so here we go. They're lined up watching for the green light. Whoa, Gordado pulls the front wheel. Still is in the lead. He had the wheelie and still is your leader. It's Gordado, 46. 33 moves into second. That's Arciero.
That bike's got power and he knows how to use it.
No kidding, man. He stood that thing straight up and down. Diana's down there. Diana, you know some more about that 46 bike.
That's right. We had Aaron Gordado, number 46, on our pre-show here tonight. Lance, he's quite the guest. He was talking about how lately he's been having a little bit of issues falling. We're going to see him keep it on two wheels here tonight in Milwaukee for Flat Out. Are we going to see him on the podium here tonight?
Well, right now he slipped out of a transfer spot, 67 in the lead. That's Haupt. And in second now is the 17 bike of Fisher. Fisher was on the pole for this one. Oh, we lose one coming off of turn number two. Hopefully he stays out of the way. They told him during the riders meeting to get the heck out of the way. It's the 9 bike.
It's so incredible. 50-plus riders out here, all names we want to see in the main event,
yeah.
And they're only taking two from each.
Two from each of the semis. We already got some of the riders transferred out of the heat races, so we'll see a lot of fast guys, but maybe just not all of them in that main event. Last lap, here they come. White flag still flying. 67's your leader. He's got his hands full with the 17 bike. 67-17 across the line, almost at the same time. out, doing a little heel clicker.
He's doing some freestyle out there.
Oh, look at that. Somebody doing a burnout. Turn number two.
Oh, you see the smoke.
There we go. That's what was going down last night at the Fuel Cafe.
That's what a hooligan is right there.
Yeah, there's a hooligan for you. He said, I'm not in the main event. I don't need that tire anymore. Yep. Let's take a look at the pass early on in this one. This is hooligan semi-final number one. Pass for the lead. The 67 goes up the inside slides. Gordado wide. I believe that opened up the door for the 17 bike as well. So for you new fans out there, you want to stay down low on the shortest way around, but he slid wide, and that allowed two bikes to go on by. Man, we got a smoke show behind us.
Yeah. The arena smoked out, and you could just see that when Gordado was out there, he kind of left the door open. He kind of was his bike was stood up, and he got past.
Yeah, he opened up the door a little bit too far, and they definitely took advantage of it. So we'll take a look at the finish once again here. That one is the 67 bike coming across. There's the white flag. Here they come. They caught up to a lap rider, and they came across the checkered flag. There's the lap rider right there. So it was a really tight race across that finish line. Again, the 67 bike taking the win. That is Haupt out there on the Harley-Davidson. We're trying to let some of the smoke dissipate. There's a good look at the crowd down there in the pit area. I see national number 29, Jake Mattia down there, standing there. He's watching the track and watching to see what's happening. He'll be riding the 35L bike. Let's go down to Diane. Diane, are you down there in the smoke show?
Yeah, that's right. I am down here in the smoke show. You guys can see me right over here. Or not, actually. It's zooming out. But I'm in the tunnel right now. You guys have got to see this, the mass amount of riders we have coming through this small, narrow area. Over 250 entries here alone tonight, guys. Loads of bikes fill these hallways.
Well, it looks pretty crowded down there. We're bringing them out. Hooligan semi number two. We got another 67 with a different Haupt on it. 24 is Tucker. 44Z is Hansen. 41 Johnson. 66X is Burhau. Jordan Baber out there on the 72 bike. Jeremy DeRider, used to be national number 34, is out there. 70 is James. That's Paul James. Works for the Harley-Davidson factory. Dan Mischler on the 77 bike and Zielinski on the 618. So we got Harleys, a KTM, and a Suzuki out there. Mischler, number 77 on a Suzuki.
I love that these bikes are technically street legal bikes. Take these number plates off, put a headlight on it, and you're basically rolling these on the road.
Look at that 44 bike pulling up to the inside. It wasn't supposed to be inside on our list, but they used to race those. That's a ZX1200R. They used to race those, road race those. And my buddy Bubba Blackwell, the professional Harley-Davidson stunt rider and jumper, he actually has an XR1200 that I call my bike because I help him out sometimes. But nice. They're fun bikes, man. They're a lot of fun. There's Jordan Baber out there. He's been running this hooligan stuff all across the country. And he's getting pretty fast on that 72 bike. He's got a little bit of help from S&S with those new S&S pipes on there. Mag front wheel. Would you ride this class?
I would love to ride this class. But it's just as fun kind of sitting up here watching it all go down and chiming in and hanging with you.
Yeah, man, this is a blast. I'm smiling ear to ear, and I'm not even out there riding. So Mischler was on the 77 bike. He was listed here on the Suzuki, but he just rode by in a Harley. 44D, I don't have a 44D on my list, but 44Z on my list is Hansen. So they don't have much time. We're not going to wait for him very long. So they're taking a look down there. I see somebody's grabbing a spark plug wrench over here. Where the entrance to the track is what they're working on. Check it out. That's a Camel Pro front number plate on the 67 bike.
I'm digging
that. That's old school, man.
I'm checking out how some guys have moto dirt bike helmets and some guys have sport bike helmets, street bike helmets.
Well, 67 was supposed to be on the pole on my list. That's Haupt. And it's listed here as a Harley, so that's a Buell, right? That's a Buell?
Yep, that's a Buell.
With the red, white, and blue paint job on there.
Yes, sir.
So 67, that's the style of the... used to be number 67, Bubba Schobert. He ended up being a couple-time champion, Grand National champion. Went on to be a road racing world champion, too. Bubba Schobert used to run the numbers just like that. Making some adjustments to the 77. Looks like he...
Is he running?
Yep. Well,
right.
Where are you going?
Oh, he's going out there.
Shoves in the gear.
Now, did you say he has the pole?
He was supposed to be out there row number two, but he was listed here on the Suzuki, so he's made a switch to Harley. That's Mischler. Again, this is the biggest class, 54 hooligans signed up. Two of these riders going to the main. 44D grabs the hole, shot on the inside, 72 of Baber on the outside. Baber, your new leader. Oh, 24 just about went flying. 72.44.
See that S&S bike out there out front. Nice big blue bike.
Beautiful machine right there. The 44 bike, keeping him honest right there. He's taking a look up the inside.
Now in the past, I've seen those, whether the XR1200s?
Yeah, the taller ones.
I've seen those bikes do real well here.
And he's taking a look up the inside. They actually used to have a road race team with the exact same paint job on those. He looks like he's holding off some fast company. 34, Jeremy DeRider out there from Wisconsin. He used to be national number 34. He's right there in the third spot. We lost one on the back straightaway.
Uh-oh.
He picked it up. He's all right.
And down.
And down. Trying to get some friends to pick up his motorcycle. 44 still in the second spot, holding off the 34. Tough break for 24 of Tucker. Laps are winding down. White flag is out. Looks like the leader's holding up the gang a little bit. They got a little squirrely back there behind him, didn't they?
Yeah, you don't want to be dancing out there with a 500-600-pound motorcycle. No,
absolutely not. There is your winner. Baber taking the win. The 44 getting the other transfer spot. That's a 44D. On my list, I got a 44C of Hansen. You see air horns going off just like we're at a MotoGP, man. This is cool.
That's right.
Diana, tell us about the 22 bike coming out.
That's right. We interviewed him. He was on our pre-show, and it's Mark Atkins, actually. He's running a cell phone on the front handlebars. If you guys can see this right here. This is a cell phone. He's running a tuner app. He wants to get his bike up to 200 degrees. He says that his bike actually runs better being that hot. So really awesome seeing the tuner app up and live right now.
How hot is it right now, Diana?
It was running about 160 degrees right now, just sitting here. So he's getting it up to that 200 mark.
Will he leave that on there while he's racing?
He'll leave it on there while he's racing. And then he was even showing me Instagram, you guys, and Facebook. So he might be on Facebook Live just like us right now.
Is that your phone or is that his phone?
No. Yeah, maybe I gave him my phone.
I don't know. It didn't look like it's pink.
No, I don't have a pink phone. That's his phone, you guys. And
okay.
He has lots of fun stuff happening right now.
Well, I'm about ready to run out of lineups, so hopefully we're running out of races.
Not only that, but then we have 85, Buddy Suttle, right behind him, who was also on our pre-show. So it's becoming a pretty stacked class. We have the 66 lined up back here as well, another Gordado brother.
It takes just a second. They're cleaning up the track in different spots. If there's some fluid that's laid down out there, Lance, it gets really, really slick when it's on top of that Dr. Pepper syrup. So they got to make sure all the liquid's cleared off. That's what they're doing in the different corners. We have two hooligan semifinals up next. We'll take the top two out of each of them. The 22, that is the Rusty Butcher, right? That's what we have listed here.
Yeah, Rusty Butcher. Yeah. Mark Atkins, like she was saying. But he's done a really good job of kind of branding himself as Rusty Butcher. I've met people that thought his name was actually Rusty Butcher.
That's what I thought. I saw him last night out there at the Fuel Cafe. He was having some fun with a bunch of people who were out there. So it was a good time. Suttle out there on the 85 bike. He'll be starting second. And this one looks like they're all Harley Davidsons. 182 is Klee. 3X is Jones. 816 Pope. 37X is Canavan. 78, don't have a name on him. Gordado, that's Sean Gordado on the 66 bike. Hopefully he has a little bit better run than his brother just did. 70X is Evans and Samuelson on the 17X bike. So two of these bikes will make it onto the final. The rest of them are done for the night.
This is a stacked class right here.
Absolutely. It's the hooligan class, the biggest class of the night. There are 11 classes tonight. 260 entries here tonight. You see the rag underneath that 67 bike over there. That's probably what they're trying to clean up the fluid on the track from the 67 machine.
Is that Mark Atkins trying to show off in front of Buddy Suttle that
no,
he can do a wheelie too?
No way.
It looked like it.
When a guy gets on a motorcycle in front of people, you don't show off, do you?
Well, Buddy Suttle right there, he's known for his wheelies, and Mark did one right in front of him, so I think he's taunting him before the race even starts.
Well, maybe he is.
And they're lining up right next to each other.
Man, no pressure. No pressure, right?
No pressure.
The third rider's got a Rusty Butcher shirt on, too.
That's right.
Maybe his name's Rusty Butcher also. Diana, where you at?
That's right, guys. I'm down here trackside. 22 lined up on the start line. We were having him on the pre-show. He said he is nothing but serious about this race. He's won it before, and he wants to win it again. Will we see him as number one here tonight in the main event?
Well, he's got a long ways to go, Diana. He's got to come through the semifinal just to make it into the main event. So he's got to finish in the top two in this one to make it on into the main event. They're lining him up. They're about ready to go racing once again. We have two more hooligan semis left.
Uh-oh. Buddy Suttle out to a quick lead. Mark Atkins right there, though, trying to make sure he gets in this race.
The Rusty Butcher right there in second. One rider against the wall. Rusty Butcher on the ground.
Oh, no.
Rusty Butcher goes down to the ground. Atkins.
Guys, I'm right here in the corner. The Butcher, he slid out. Buddy Suttle taking over the lead. Amazing. This is Buddy Suttle's only second race here.
Well, I hope he didn't break his cell phone.
Neither, right?
Right.
I hope he didn't do.
Man, that'd be an expensive night.
Right. Those are on payment plans nowadays.
Right, exactly. Out in front, your leader Suttle on the 85 bike. Two riders going to the main event. Battle is now heating up for second place. 816 and a 182. Cleat on the 182. 816 is Pope. Two riders going on to the main. 85 looks like he's in pretty good control. This one will pick up the white flag next time by. One lap to go. Battle still tight for second place. 182 has it. Here comes the checkered flag for your winner on the back wheel. 85, Suttle takes the win. Oh, riders going down after the checkered flag. That's Pope going down, throwing it away. All right, that was a great race out there, hooligan semi. Number three, we'll take a look at the replay here. We'll see what happened to Sean Gordado on the 66 bike. So wasn't the night for the Gordados from California. Here's a look at it. Again, bumping and banging early on. Watch the middle of the screen.
Oh,
he got T-boned from somebody else, and then he had nowhere to go. 70 bike had absolutely nowhere to go. And here's a look at what happened to Rusty Butcher.
Oh.
Got in there a little bit too hot, but that's much better than high siding for sure.
Buddy Suttle held his line, and Mark Atkins just, he couldn't turn that sharp.
Well, it's really hard to do. When there's a bike sliding in front of you, you try to lay it over as far as you can, and it just looked like it got a little bit too far, and it just dropped it over there. So tough break for him.
I know Mark's really bummed. Do they have an LCQ?
I don't know. I don't have an LCQ on my list, so that might be it for him. There's a look at the 85 bike. White flag. This is the last lap for him. He caught up to some lap traffic, too. No harm, no foul for Suttle out there on the 85 machine. Smooth sailing for him of what's on the back wheel across the line. 85 on the Harley Davidson, and there is one more semifinal for the hooligans coming up next.
I know they're real bums standing over there on the side.
Yeah, absolutely. Sean Gordado and Aaron, his brother, both came from California, long ways to go.
Well, man. Sean's crashed a couple times at the most recent races.
Yeah,
he crashed earlier today also.
In practice?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's... Tonight's broadcast is brought to you by the all-new Harley-Davidson Iron 1200 and 48 Special. One with dark custom style and corner cranking performance, the other retro cool with modern swagger. Check out both of them at h-d.com/sportster. And by Screaming Eagle Performance, enhance the look and feel of your Harley-Davidson with their powerful lineup of performance-enhancing upgrades. Check them out at ScreamingEagle.com. Final hooligan semifinal coming to the track, 45 Flaherty. Terry Bestel, number 27, 97 is Lauders, 81 Winkler, 44 Gonzalez, 1901 is Warden on the Indian, 115 is Drake, 477 Tucker, 10 is Gregory, and 84 is Ed Subias. Keep an eye on that 45 bike. That guy is fast. So is Terry Bestel on the 27 bike.
Well, I know it's JJ, right? Number 44?
Yep. 45, JJ Flaherty.
45. I know JJ's been winning some stuff. He's local to here. I know he wants to show off to his local fans.
Man, he looked good at the X Games last year, too. He's got those bright white leathers on.
He won X Games last year, isn't that right?
I believe so. JJ rides, man. He's a good rider out there. It's a surprise to see him in the semifinal. The 27, Terry Bestel, he's been racing for a long time. I get to announce him quite a bit at some amateur races there in Illinois and throughout the area when I get to do some other races besides the Grand National Flat Track Series. I can't wait to catch up what's going on Facebook. All these people will send us messages and stuff like that, so we'll try to do that here pretty soon. Last semifinal for the hooligans are lined up right now. There's four of them, and the top two going to the main event. Here we go. The RPMs pick up. Clutches come out. JJ rides up the inside, taking the lead.
You think he's going to run away with this?
I don't know. Vestal's pretty quick on indoors. He's right there in second, but JJ got a good start. Great start, actually. Look how far up on the gas tank he's riding.
Yep, I really love the look of that bike.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
I love the classic styling. I love the chrome wheels.
It's a good-looking motorcycle. He's got a little bit of wheel chatter going into the corners. That's when you're on the brakes a little bit too hard. There's one down right in the middle of the straightaway. They're going to keep on going. They said they're going to go until there's a red flag. If the track is blocked, and they'll shut them down. Or if somebody gets hurt, we'll shut them down. If not, we keep racing. J.J. Flaherty out there on the Harley-Davidson's way. He's listed out here on the 45 machine. Vestal in second.
Lost a little traction that
time. Got a
little
bit sideways. Vestal's right there, the 27 bike. Here they come to the white flag here. The next time by, they'll pick up the white. Here comes Vestal on the big Harley. Vestal thought about looking up the inside, but he said, nah, I'll just take my transfer spot. I'll wait for the main event.
That's right. This main event is going to be stacked.
Absolutely. Checkered flag is out for the 45 of Flaherty. Terry Vestal, number 27, will pick up second place.
I'm reading some comments right here. Ron from Daytona, Ohio. Jason Rogers, rooting for Bound Bear Racing. A lot of JJ fans.
Absolutely.
Chris, Marion.
Man, lots of people are tuning in. I'm getting people hit me up on Twitter and stuff like that.
Another Corey Thomas.
Right on.
Rooting for Brown Bear. Kurt rooting for JJ. I see people from Texas. I see people from Georgia, California. Taz from Canada. It's just
lots of people tuning in. Terry Reimer out there, Black Hills Harley Davidson.
Wait a second, is that Larry and Tyser just chilling right
there? Sure. Look, he's talking to Diana. I said Diana. Larry and Tyser's here. This is the hooligan Concy race. Maybe Diana will catch up to the Enticer down there. We'll see if we can catch up to it. So this is the Concy race. These are the riders that didn't even make it into a heat race. We had so many bikes, we eliminated bikes. So these are the riders that didn't get to run a heat race, that didn't make it to a semifinal. I don't have a list, so we're just gonna watch some racing and listen to these guys have some fun. 462, the 315, and the 18 bike. It's called the Hooligan Concy.
Looks like we have a Rusty Butcher employee out there.
Oh, light turns green. I don't think some of these guys are ready. The 462's got the lead. He's got the traction.
Yep. Now he practices with Rusty Butcher and his boys every
right
day, so he's got a little advantage.
The folks from Bill Built Pipes tuning in South Dakota, listening in. Stacy Cooper out there on the West Coast in California. They're watching Flat Out Friday on Facebook. Also, Tim Humphreys, BHD. He's got it live and loud in Ohio. Hooligan. Man, the Hooligan, this is the Concy race. Leader's pulling away in a hurry.
I think he's going to lap him.
He's putting it on him, isn't he? He must have had some problems earlier in the day because he looks like he's plenty fast enough to make it into the semifinal.
Yeah.
And there's the checkered flag for the Hooligan Concy race. He puts it on the back wheel. Is that what you'd do, right?
That's what I would do. That's right.
You want to race, you got to do it.
Running that thing on the rev limiter.
Yeah. That's what they're there for, though, so they don't blow them up, right? You got a rev limiter on your 450, don't you?
I think so.
Yeah.
So you don't... I've used it a couple times when I was upside down before.
When you're like, here is a look at the restart, the Hooligan Concy. Yep, one rider was ready for sure. The other one's like, Oh, it's green. Let's go. Let's go down to Diana. Diana, where are you at now?
Guys, I'm standing here with the most famous snowmobiler of all time, Larry Enticer. Oh, my God. It is an honor to be standing here next to you. How has Flat Out Friday been so far?
It's pretty amazing. There's a lot of fast bikes and a lot of carnage going on.
Talking about carnage, it seems as if we've heard some rumors that you're going to be out here racing tonight. Will we see that?
Yeah, I might come out in the, I forget what the class is called. But.
Inappropriate class. You might be out here on a snow sled, guys. For those of you watching our live feed, give a thumbs up. Where can we find you at? We all know your Instagram sensation. Let everybody who's watching our feed right now know where they can find the Larry Enticer.
just at Larry and Tyser, and you'll find it all there.
Yeah, you're going to see these sweet glasses, these jean jackets, and that lovely mullet. Scotty, Lance, take it away.
Man, it looks like a lot of fun down there. You never know who you're going to find out here at Flat Out Friday. Coming up next, we have the, what is this, the bike build class?
This is a pretty cool situation. It looks like it's a nonprofit educational organization that's dedicated to pairing teams of high school students with bike building mentors in a collective effort to learn valuable life and in-personal skills while working on motorcycles. These are bikes built by them. They're out there racing on. I wish when I was in high school that teachers could have paired me up with other motorcycle enthusiasts, other people who knew how to work on stuff, and we could have built something and raced it.
Man,
like this.
It's such a cool program. These bikes were actually built to go road racing. They've taken the fairings off of them. They're going to go flat track racing here tonight. This next group of students that's working on the bikes, they're actually building flat track racing machines. So next year, you're going to see some flat track racing bikes out there. I don't have any names for these riders out there. The 35L, that is Charlotte Keynes' old number, and that bike looks just like the number plates from Charlotte. I'm not sure if that's Jack Keynes. I think it might be out there. 50 out there. 1795. Here we go. They're about to take off, and they are off. And this is the bike build class.
That it's such a great opportunity for these guys to build something during school and come out here and put it to the test.
That is Jack Haynes out in front, Charlotte Keynes' dad, running the number 35L. That was his daughter's number, and he is doing it proud out in front of this one, the bike build class. And he's going away with it.
So basically, it's like the students get to build the bike with their mentors.
Absolutely.
And the mentor is actually out there riding it right now.
He's showing them the fast way around the track, too. Jack Keynes in the lead, 95 in second, 50 in the third spot. Probably some of the first times these guys have ever raced an indoor race, much less on concrete. And then you throw some Dr. Pepper syrup on top of that, and then you do it in front of this great big crowd. So it's a cool deal. Jack Keynes out there pulling away, number 35. He used to always give me a time when I announced his daughter, Charlotte. I used to say West Alice. No, I said West Elise.
Yep.
And he says West Alice, Wisconsin. So he's from not too far, about 30 minutes down the road from here. And he's actually lapping some of the riders. Checkered flag is going to come out right now. Jack Keynes going to take the win on the 35L bike, which is really cool. We'll see Jake Mattia running the same number plate later on. It is actually Charlotte Keynes' 450 in our expert class. That's such a cool class. Now we're so the winner went on off back into the pits. That was Jack Kane. We're trying to get a word with them. We got a short intermission, looks like, coming up here pretty quickly already. Man.
Crowd's filling up. I see a lot of those orange shirts out there.
Dude, they're all from Uke's Harley-Davidson, not too far down the road. Lots of stuff happening down here. Full crowd. We're scheduled for an intermission break. We got a kids race coming up. We're gonna have some pit. Oh, look at this.
Yeah.
Some bicycles coming out. It's a kids race.
So awesome.
So we got some big horsepower rides, power wheels, some Strider bikes, and some scooters. Dude, the crowd's louder for these guys than anybody else. Look at the one at the back.
Wow.
Lance, I don't know if you can see the guy at the back of the pack. He's on the Strider bicycle with a green helmet. They're still coming out of the pit area. This might be the new biggest class.
My little 18-month-old daughter, Luca, would love to be out there right now on her Strider.
She has a Strider bike?
Yep, she'd be like that.
Perfect. You know, guys, all three of us have kids, and it's like this is where it's born at right here. This is where you introduce them, classes like this, events like these, that you get to plant the seed and hopefully take away our dreams that we get to live every weekend.
When I was about 4 or 5 years old, I went over to the Metrodome back in Minneapolis and rode a big wheel on a concrete indoor. Man, that was a long time ago. Oh, what? Look, the little girl got there in a hurry.
This is so cool.
Man, she just pulled up there at the last second.
The crowd is louder than ever right now.
Absolutely. I don't think they can hear us right now, but they have an in-track announcer also, so they're pumping them up right here beside us and having a good time out there. The kids' class are getting ready to take off.
I'm loving that everyone on social media is digging it.
Mark,
I see Kenny Bristol loving it. I see Sonia loving it. I see Sean from Ohio.
Yeah, the crowd yelling go. Look, he's got E.T. in the front in the basket. He's got E.T. along with him.
That's right. I was going to say, coming around the first turn, E.T., I mean, he has the full getup, even the hooded sweatshirt.
Man. There he comes. He got his tongue sticking out, too.
That is awesome. You see
Look at the little girl in second place.
I can get an interview. We can get an interview.
Double checkered flag. E.T. went on by you, Diana.
See if you can get anyone for an interview.
Trying to get someone, guys.
We want to see the excitement on these kids' faces.
They're still coming. Here comes the Strider bike. The crowd's going nuts. Two little girls.
Go, go, go.
Yeah.
Oh.
Just about lost E.T.
Pull one of them aside if you can. I'd love to see how the excitement on their face. They don't want to stop. I don't think they're still going.
Yeah. Well, they're having fun. Oh, this guy's about got a high-speed wobble on the back straightaway. Whew. There goes E.T. Man, they're having some fun out there.
Let's go.
Look at the
bring
E.T.
Bring it
head
on
going
down
back
to me, guys, because I have someone here.
Well, tell us about it.
All right. So are you going to tell me your name?
Max.
Max. What's your last name, Max? What's Max's last name, Dad?
Max Heyer.
Max Heyer. And did you know your daddy puts on this, is a part of the team that puts on this awesome event?
Yes.
How do you like it?
Yes.
Yes, he likes it, everyone. Give a big round of applause for these kids. Then we have the winner who's rocking E.T. What is your name, young man?
Cole Ketterhagen.
Cole, you have just won the kids class at Flat Out Friday. How does that make you feel?
Good.
How was E.T.? Was he your partner in crime tonight?
Yeah.
Awesome. Do you want to thank Mom and Dad?
Yes.
All right, he's thanking Mom and Dad. What? Well, we got one more. What's your name?
Bye.
What was that?
Bye.
Okay, hi or bye. I don't know. But you know what? It looks like we got a Norton number 88 on the back of his shirt. So this is what it's all about here. This is where Flat Out Friday begins, guys. Give a big round of applause. And if you're watching the feed, give a huge thumbs up for these little kids coming out here and putting a show on for you guys.
Man, how fun was that? That was so cool.
Biggest smile on my face right now because I can imagine my kid out there just loving it.
And the crowd was eating it up too. So we're going to take a short break, ladies and gentlemen. We come back from intermission. It's going to be our brakeless class, our brakeless motorcycle main event coming up next. We'll be right back. Tonight's broadcast is brought to you by the all-new Harley-Davidson Iron 1200 and 48 Special. One with dark custom style and corner cranking performance, the other retro cool with modern swagger. Check out both of them at h-d.com/sportster. And by Screaming Eagle Performance, enhance the look and feel of your Harley-Davidson with their powerful lineup of performance-enhancing upgrades. Check them out at ScreamingEagle.com. Folks, we're out here at Flat Out Friday up here in Milwaukee. It's time for a short intermission break, ladies and gentlemen. When we come back, it'll be time for our main events up here in Milwaukee. We'll be back quickly after intermission.
Dancing horses, beautiful.
Whoa, I saw sparks.
As their capes blow in the wind.
You know, this
this is really a sport unto itself. This free riding, trick riding is really awesome. It takes years of practice to get stuff down like this.
Yeah, we took great precautions to make sure we kept all the hooligans out of the Bradley Center tonight. Security is on full alert. Anybody wearing leather and bones, well, they just had to stay outside.
Keep us out of here. We will take this day. Yes, my dogs, ride. Ride. Show them who is boss. Show them that we are truly evil. Yes. They're minus little. Nobody is impressed by a wheelie. Go home. We don't care. Yes, bar your teeth. Show them your claws. Take them, my dogs. Take them all. Push them from this track. How dare you keep us off this
track? I don't know. Never trust a man in a leather bondage mask. Oh, there's a chainsaw on the course.
All right, we got an axe, a chainsaw. What's those four guys doing down there? They look like they're ready to attack.
Have we as a society collectively lost our minds?
Yes, run them out of the way.
Oh, here comes another Knievel.
Wait. My puppies, bring them to this end. We shall own this day. We will tell these evils who is boss. Close off the roads. My dogs, line the door, line the walls. Keep them from passing. Wait. Is that a zombie evil coming from the grave?
I don't know. I'm going to have to give the security a great
big eyes help. Deceive me? Has evil Knievel actually risen from the grave? My puppies, take them. Show them who is boss. Come, my foot soldiers.
Oh, it's zombie evil Knievel come to avenge from the grave.
All right.
It's complete chaos at the Bradley Center. Oh.
What is going on down there?
Kids, don't try this at home. Looks like Zombie Knievel has the upper hand on these Australian punks. These leather-clad Oh, goodness. That's going to hurt tomorrow. Oh, boy. Kids, look away. Oh, goodness.
Zombie Knievel's not giving up.
This is not how we want a workout problem.
Good thing zombies can't feel what just happened to him.
Oh, there's a Sith. Oh my goodness. Oh, look out for your head, Zombie Evil Knievel. Oh boy. He took hits to the head.
Zombie Knievel's getting a beat down.
Zombie Knievel is down.
Boo the Mad Max crew.
Get this Mad Max crew out of here. Back to New South Wales with the lot of you. Won't somebody think of the children? Oh, Zombie Knievel is down, but for how long? We'll have to take him to the zombie hospital to the
Get a brain transplant. Good, they're all leaving.
Good riddance. Yeah. Good riddance, Mad Max.
Good riddance to bad garbage.
I hope you're proud of yourselves leaving a zombie American hero on the track.
Why you gotta kill him again? He's already dead, for God's sake.
Kids, this is not how we work out problems in the real world.
Violence settles nothing unless you're killing a zombie. Evil Knievel on Flat Out Friday. Then apparently it does. Can somebody remove the zombie from the racetrack, please?
In a Flat Out Friday first, we have to remove a zombie corpse from the track. We might need a little more Dr. Pepper over there.
Can we set him up like a jump? We'll put a hunk of plywood on him. We'll just jump him. I'm pretty sure I jumped somebody in a race already.
Uh-oh. I guess we'll just start up the next race.
But we can't. We got greasy, grimy gopher zombie guts in there. Can't do that. Yeah, drag his zombie butt out of here.
All right.
Say goodbye to the zombie, kids. Everybody
bye,
say goodbye, zombie.
Zombie.
He's the man who created this entire event right there. It's the man.
welcome back to Flat Out Friday. That was one heck of an intermission break.
That was. I was on my feet.
A little Mad Max tribute, Evel Knievel. Man, we had a lot of fun. Now we've narrowed the field down to just our main events, Lance, and this is where it's going to get really good.
We're going to get a lot of bar banging right now because, as you see, sometimes the first and second guy would start to pull away from the pack. We're not going to have that anymore. These are the top 8 or 12 guys out there.
Well, what I saw in the semifinals, some of the guys would get way out in front, and then they'd just back off. You don't have a chance to back off in the main event. This track is so small. It's a 16th of a mile, concrete with Dr. Pepper syrup on top. It's going to get really, really tight. The racing's going to get better and better.
It's going to be on their toes racing the whole time. Every class out there is stacked, basically.
Have you figured out which bike you're going to ride next year?
I would really love to be out there on the hooligans, but those guys take it so serious. I would like to push my daughter out there on the bicycle.
That'd be more fun for you?
I would be stoked.
So you won a gold medal in the X Games, but you would rather send your daughter out there for the little kids race.
It's so amazing watching stuff through your kids' eyes. You can't beat that.
It's awesome. You having a good time?
I'm having a blast. How about yourself?
Man, I've never been here before. I'm so excited. I can't wait to go see the Mama Tried motorcycle show tomorrow and check that out too. So it's such a happening up here in Milwaukee. There's so much going on. We had some fun last night at Fuel Cafe, and we got a lot of great racing coming up here in the next couple of minutes.
That's right. I mean, we already have parties lined up for when this is over.
Are you buying?
Were you invited?
No. I'm just a flat track announcer.
Oh, gotcha.
You're a gold medalist.
Gotcha.
See?
Yeah.
So, no, I wasn't invited.
We have somewhere to go, basically, right when this is over.
We have a limo?
I don't know about a limo.
Okay.
But either way, I'm really stoked to see who wins the race. And one of the crazy things I was noticing, the lineup for the hooligan class, there's a lot of names not on that list that were previous winners or some of the top five guys of last year or the year before. The class is stacking up huge.
The level of competition is getting higher and higher. So are the bikes. So are, they're building everything faster and faster. And the competition is getting stiffer and stiffer. These guys are coming from all over the place just to race up here.
Yep. And what's incredible is, I think every guy out there in the hooligan class has a 9-to-5 or some sort of job where they were working yesterday. They came here last night. They did what they could to get here, and they're coming from California. They're coming from states all over, and they are hanging it all out there.
We got here at 10 o'clock this morning. The line of motorcycles was all the way down the street. The line to get signed up was longer than that. So there's so many people. There's motorcycles all the way throughout the entire arena. They go off this way. They go all the way around the outside. There's bikes through every little crevice in this whole area. This building is awesome. The track's really cool. And it's such an event. I'm glad to be part of it. So it's been a lot of fun. I can't wait to watch these main events. There's three of us. So let's go down trackside once again and catch up with Diana.
Hey, guys, I was looking at you up on the Jumbotron, looking real nice up there, real clean up in that booth. I'm down here on the track getting real dirty. Lots of, I don't know if it's a mixture of Coke syrup, tire particles, or what down here. But it's awesome. So lively down here in the pits. We have an awesome feature. Brandon Bolstein, you guys are going to want to check it out. And make sure that if you're watching us on our Facebook live feed, you're giving us thumbs up and let us know where you're watching from.
Honestly, nobody in my immediate family was into motorcycles, but somehow I was always drawn to it. I just knew that I wanted to be on two wheels. I think it was the freedom, hopping on a motorcycle and just riding, taking you wherever you want to go. Knowing that wherever you're going to go, it's going to be a killer journey. We are in Signal Hill, California, and this is the headquarters of the Speed Merchant. This is where we design, package, ship, receive all of our products that we do for Harleys and other motorcycles. We've been focusing on the street rod that we're going to be racing this race season. So our main goal is to really just button up all the odds and ends. Fast Jay is going to be riding it this season, so we're going to be kind of fitting it up to him as far as positioning, bars, foot controls, and all that. When I picked up the street rod and brought it back here, I literally just left it alone, didn't touch it. I didn't even ride it. I just looked at it and stared at it for a while to figure out what I wanted to do with it. But being me, I got to do something to it. So I decided to use a different tank, a bolt-on tail section, dirt track tires, some handlebars, but leaving a lot more of the stock components. You know, there's a lot of things that are just kind of left alone. You really don't want to get into too many modifications because the whole point of the hooligan class is to let everybody in. Just a group of guys, a group of friends that get together and try to see who is the fastest on the track on any given day. It's not about winning or losing, it's really just about going out there and having fun.
And that was a pretty cool feature, checking out behind the scenes that we don't get to see when we're up here.
Yeah, it's rad. And it goes to show you that someone like Brandon himself, he's building his bike. He's getting out here racing. And like he said in his thing, he's working on his company. He's shipping orders. He's doing other things than just racing.
Yeah, he's having a great time. And looks like he's having a lot of fun doing it. You know, it's a very, very serious piece, but it looks like he's having fun. And he's coming out here racing with everybody else.
That's right.
Well, we got some brakeless motorcycles coming up next. Have you ever ridden a motorcycle without any brakes?
I have ridden motorcycles that didn't have brakes because they broke, but not on purpose, knowing that I'm going to go out and race with no brakes.
Well, when flat track started back in the early days, there was no brakes. They thought it was safer that way. That way, somebody in front of you couldn't just jam on the brakes and you wouldn't just run into them. So as the sport developed, they started using compression releases and other things to slow you down, and then they started putting rear brakes only. So in flat track motorcycles, it's just your rear brake only, but these bikes that are coming up next have absolutely no brakes.
Now, I'm reading the stats about it, and you have to be 18 years or older. Why wouldn't they let someone younger?
I think just experience and you know, just knowing that you want to let off the throttle early enough. So when you're young and you don't have to worry about getting up and go to work the next day, you might not let off just as soon, that soon. So, you know, maybe that's part of the rules. I know to be a professional motorcycle racer, you have to be 16 years of age, but, you know, this class, you must be 18. So there's a little bit different rules here in the brakeless class. They're all lining up down there in the staging area right now. And Diane is down there in the staging area with them.
Yeah, that's right. I'm here with Aaron Guardado getting third in his semi, which means you miss by one spot. But walk us through your semi.
I had a super good start. There was a lot more traction off the start. You get up there front end and I'm like, put the front back down and look around and led a couple of the laps, went wide and that was it, and saw someone go right by and tried to catch up, and it's a little bit hard, but well. Next year?
You know, you're really well known for the hooligans. What's it like being able to ride for Harley Davidson?
Riding with Harley Davidson has been super fun. We've gone to a lot of the races and the stand has been super empty. There's been, you know, a couple hundred people at times, and now it's packed. This is great. You know, we love the support coming to Milwaukee, riding a Harley, and come out with our friends and have a good time.
Yeah, that's right, guys. He just complimented you. Give this guy a big round of applause. Loads of fans here in the stand. We want to thank you guys all for coming out. Not only that, everyone that's watching on our live feed right now, all across the world, hundreds of channels. Thank you guys so much. Guys, take it away.
Sounds good. We're getting set for our brakeless finals. From here on out, Lance, it's just main events only. Main events.
It's going to be, like I said, it's going to be tight all night.
Yep. Brakeless final coming up. Then we'll have our Grom final, amateur final, vintage final, youth, women. And then we get into, some the boonies, mopeds, experts, hooligans. We might have a little special feature there at the very end, maybe.
Hooligans, and then what's after hooligans?
It's a secret.
Secret?
Yeah, secret.
Okay.
Or the inappropriate class.
Gotcha.
Yeah, secret. Did you just say that out loud?
I didn't say that.
All right. 260 bikes have signed up to race with us here in Milwaukee. And it is time. Diana, tell us about the class. What are the qualifications for this class?
Well, these guys have to be 18 years old. The engines must be 1981 or earlier. And there's no brakes or suspension allowed, guys. Sounds like a rough ride. Sounds like a fun ride.
Yeah, I don't know if I'd want to try this one. I mean, no brakes, no suspension, so they're rigid frames.
It sounds like the bike's not done being built.
Yep, so some of the riders are pulling out right now. Sorry, I missed what you said.
No, I mean, it sounds like these bikes are something that you shouldn't be out there riding on.
They should be set up on as trophy pieces. These are old motorcycles with no brakes. Look at that. That's a beautiful Triumph right there, the 51 bike. I've got some of the names up here. Number one is Higher. 15 is March. 198 is Pratt. Also qualified is the 88 and the 18K. 86 is Ferguson. 15 is Dickinson. 618 is Chris Zielinski. There's also another Dickinson on 26. And the 151, Scott Johnson. So we got Harley-Davidson's, BSA's, Ducati's in this one. So Harley-Davidson's, BSA, a Ducati out there. The 198 is a Ducati. No bikes are listed on the 18 or the 188. You see these guys reaching over, giving a little fist bump to each other, and they're pulling them up. The 18 bike looks like he's got some get out and push. Oh, and it fires up. So he got that bike fired up. Looks like that might be a Triumph logo on the gas tank. Maybe no, that's a Harley Davidson.
Looks like he's rolling.
Yeah, the engine's leaning forward. It's 18K, the district letter for K was up here in Wisconsin and up north. So a lot of the older style number plates. See the 198, that's like a novice plate from back in the day. That's Pratt on the 198. He's on the outside.
Do you think these guys have owned these bikes for that long and then it's actually kind of a trophy to them? They're in their house and then they pull them out to race here?
Probably some of them. You know, I'd imagine some of them have just maybe purchased these bikes and built them, you know. You don't just see these bikes laying around anywhere. The bike closest to us is the Ducati, BSA right beside them. Here we go, main event for the brakeless, getting ready to take off.
And they're off.
Some of the front wheels came up and everything. Oh, we're stacking them up.
First main event, first corner crash.
And they're still going. We go until we see a red out here in flat track. So the riders are okay. 15 is the leader, that's March. 51 going the high side, the long way around.
Guys in hay bales, I mean, this race is already off to a gnarly one. No brakes, so they're just running into walls, not stopping.
I don't have a 51, so I'm going to assume that's 151 of Scott Johnson possibly out in front. He's not on my list, though, but he is pulling away out there, and that's a beautiful-looking Triumph. You think that little seat pad out there in the rear fenders for his passenger to ride on?
I would be very stoked if there was a passenger out there right now.
Yeah, I don't think I'd do that. No suspension, that wouldn't be a very smooth ride out there, even though we're on smooth concrete.
I think that's because the bike's got so much power, he can actually fall off the seat back into that pad if he has to.
Probably so, or when you're on a big track, you can slide back and put your butt back there and get some more traction.
Yep.
51 pulling away, don't have him on our list, but he is stretching out the lead. He looks really good out there. I saw some of the guys in some of the other classes actually taking their left foot peg off so they don't drag them on the ground. Looks like everybody out there has their left foot peg on there. This guy tiptoeing through the corners as he gets into some lap traffic. There's the 86 machine of Ferguson. Leader puts him one lap down. See the British flag on the right side of the motorcycle.
Notice these guys, they get on the gas and about halfway through that straight, they actually have to let off.
So they coast through the corner so they don't blow the corner because, again, yep, no brakes. So you drag your feet as much as you can. He's got carpet on the bottom of his boot, it looks like.
Watch his throttle hand. He's letting off halfway through that straight.
Last lap as the white flag is out. Main event for the brakeless class. Here comes the double checkered flag. And your winner, number 51. He'll try to stop that motorcycle, but remember, there's no brakes. So it takes him a lap to slow down. He actually has to downshift that motorcycle. He'll slow down and come back around. He'll meet up with Diana Dahlgren down there in just a second. But, man, I don't know. The brakeless class is pretty cool.
That was an exciting start, I'll tell you that.
Yeah, 51 out there taking the win. Don't have a name on him on our sheet, so maybe Diana will hopefully catch up to our winner there in just a second. Up next will be our Grom main event coming up in just a second. Let's go trackside to tonight's winner in the brakeless class.
Here with 51, Randy Berry taking home and dominating the win here for the brakeless class. Tell us how you did it and tell us who you're thanking here tonight.
It's getting a little slick out there. Just kind of stayed with one line and tried not to fall down.
All right. Well, who do you have to thank for coming out here tonight?
I have to tell you.
Who are you thanking to come out here tonight?
I just want to thank my brother Bob. This is his bike, and another guy, Melvin Long from Indiana, for letting me ride the bike.
All right. Well, congratulations, Randy Berry, thanking his brother Bob for giving him the bike. Guys, take it away.
Absolutely, definitely a family sport is flat track. Up next will be the Grom main event, ladies and gentlemen. Number 505 is Zesco. 77 is Mishler, 37 is Smith, 84 is also Mishler, 44 is Jacobson, 29L is Van Banglin, 352 is Denovan, and the 702 is Kenny Dahl, and the 172 is Chekowitz. Easy for you to say. These are the Groms, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, that's right, guys. We have the Grom class back in here, which means that they have to be running a stock Grom. Not only that, they need to be running the Kawasaki Z125 Pro only. Remove the kickstand, turn signals, license plate display, mirrors, and the rear foot pegs.
So no pro riders can come out there. Looks like only three of them have pulled up to the line so far. 505 Zesco, 77 Mishler, 317 Smith. There's also another Mishler on the 84 bike. Dan Jacobson on the 44 bike, 29L is Vanglin, 352 is Denovan, Kenny Dahl on the 702, and Chekowitz on the 172. Looks like a bunch of Groms, actually all of the Groms, and there's one Honda. Looks like Honda is the Groms, so it looks like they're all Groms in this one. There was Kawasaki's entered also, but looks like we narrowed it down to just...
Does that mean that the Groms are a better bike?
I don't know. Maybe I think the Groms are a little bit more popular than the Kawasaki version. I see a green bike out there, but... Maybe just some green decals on the 84 machine. Grom class last year, I think Corey Texter took the win, but they changed the rules where no pros can ride in this class.
That's no fun.
Well, I don't know.
Pros should be able to have fun too.
Well, I think Corey Texter won, and he actually won the Kawasaki version of the Grom, so he won a bike.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so I think that's why they changed the
rules.
This
is the class I want to race then, because I want to leave with one.
You want one of those?
Yes.
For your daughter?
No, me.
Oh, for you?
My collection.
Oh, for your collection of motorcycles. You don't have enough already?
No. In fact, I really want a Harley short stir, those little Harleys that they used to make.
Yep.
Made it for 1 year.
Can you ever have too many motorcycles?
No, you can't.
I don't think so either. Lining them up, getting set to go. One more bike just joined the starting back to the packs of 77. That is Dan Mishler, I believe. There's a couple Mishlers out there. Eric Mishler's also out there. Dan is on the 77. Eric Mishler's on the 82. So that's who just joined us. 77 said, nope, I'm supposed to be on the pole, but I think if you get there late, you need to start the back.
Yeah, that's right.
Nope, he's going to make you start the back. You were late.
Really?
Tell him, I would. That's what they do at the Grand Nationals. You missed your starting call. You actually might not even get to start at a Grand National.
Really?
If you're supposed to be there at a National before the checkered flag flies of the previous race. Oh, they're going to put him all the way on the inside?
I mean, that's a fair deal, right? He was arguing.
I'd put him on the back. If it was me, put him on the back. He was late. We had to wait for him.
But he obviously was the fastest qualifier, so do you think he's going to be able to pull this off?
Man, it's going to be hard from the outside for sure. He's going to have to shut everybody else down. Or, like you said earlier, back off and then tuck inside of everybody. So
Yep. We'll
see. Here we go with our Grom main event.
Oh.
Uh-oh.
We had a little jump of 505.
505, is that his area code, you think?
That's a good guess.
I don't know. Oh, where is he? He's going to go to the back row. So he was on the second row. No, you know, at that point, you have nothing to lose. You're starting on the second row anyway, so you might as well try to sneak off there a little bit. I like the 29's number plate. That's the old Camel Pro sticker on top. Former national number 29, a good friend of mine, Scotty Adams. He had a Camel Pro number plate. Looked very similar to that. Here we go. Light turns green. They're bumping and banging and going wide in turn one. Woo. Who's out front? Whoa!
Oh.
High side. He's up already, but he's missing some bike parts.
They call that a yard sale.
Yeah. Yep. I didn't see the sign, but I see the parts. 317 is your leader. That is Smith. Smith out there in the 317s. That's Jake Smith from Oak Creek, Wisconsin. Oh,
oh!
Leader throws it away. 505's in the lead.
Yep.
He's one that jumped.
I think he was the one that jumped. It looked like it.
Or that's the guy that fell. That's the guy that fell.
No, he didn't fall. The guy that fell had the same color jersey on, but like normal jeans.
Well, that's why
right
I got confused.
Right there. 172 was the guy that fell.
Right. So check him out. He's wearing tennis shoes and his Stance socks.
Yep.
Yep.
I mean, the thing is, these bikes are so small that when you're in boots, it's actually sometimes hard to feel the shifter or the brake.
Absolutely. I mean, it makes sense, but on these little bitty bikes, you know, the shifter and the brake are so close to the foot peg, it'd be very hard.
You're taking possible ankle injuries or right. feeling the
or
bike.
Or touching the brake or the shifter. Yeah, exactly. So 505 is Zesco. Jesco out in front. He's from Waupun, Wisconsin. Finish Line Engines, his sponsor is Jacob Jesco on the 505 machine. You can see him actually pick his foot off and turn it completely off of the brake pad. That's what my dad and my grandpa used to teach me. You get your foot completely off that brake. You don't want to be dragging it. You don't want to touch it at all. Last lap.
You see these bikes hopping around so much. Is it because they're too big for the bike?
Yeah, they're way overworking the suspension. Oh, another rider goes down the last corner. A high five from the 505. Jesco. One guy threw it away at the very end. He's pretty pumped up. Wonder if there's any parts left over there from the yard sale. I think they got sold them already. Let's look at some of the replays of the early action. There goes the yard sale right there.
Yep.
There is leaving pieces all over the place. Here is the battle for the lead, I think, as we watch the leader throw it away. 317 was out front, and he just tucked the front wheel. That's a nice low side. That's the safest way to lay it down. And now let's go track side with our tonight's winner of the Grom class.
The number 505, Jacob Jesco, taking the win and dominating here at Flat Out Friday.
Thank you. Yeah, it was a great night. I'd really like to thank my parents for letting me come out tonight. And Finish Line Engines, they've been a huge help to me this whole season. So it's just been a great day overall. Thanks.
All right, well, congratulations, Jacob, taking the overall here for the Grom class.
Absolutely. Looks like he's pretty stoked to take the win out here. Up next, the Open Amateur Final. This will be a big one. I mean, we've narrowed the field down, but we've got it down to the fastest guys. 44 is Bush. 22 is Myman. 69 is Smith. 32, Mitchell. 90 is Lang. 07, don't have a name right there. Jacob Walter on the 43. Westfall on the 33. Dan Jacobson, 441. Jordan Jean, 56. 649 is Telzap, and the 516 is Gorky. I believe the 07. Yeah, Open Amateur Final getting set to go. 07, Ezra Bruski. Diana's still down there on the track. Diana, tell us about the rules of this class.
The participants are 12 years or older. They must be 14 years old to ride a 450. There is no brakeless bikes allowed here. The bikes must be fully framed with 150 minimum cc's. So guys, we're going to see what they can put down for the main event tonight.
Some of these guys and girls in this one are the future stars of the American Flat Track Tour. You have to work your way through the amateur ranks, make your way up there, and then move into pro. These are still open amateur class, and it's the fastest of the fast what we have left. That's Ezra Bruski on the 07. I didn't have his name earlier.
Earlier when we were talking about Ezra on the 07, she is actually not even 15, guys. She just turned 14 years old. I actually got corrected when I said she's 15. No, she's 14, and she won the semi. So it's going to be interesting to see what she does here.
And she's got a pretty good starting spot, moving up there quite a ways. Also, check it out. Jackie Mitchell out there, part of the class of 79 and friends. He's out there on his Bull Taco in the center of the front row. So that's an old 1970s machine, the 69 bike. We were calling him Evil Knievel earlier today, and then he's listed out here on a Bull Taco too, but I'm not sure if that's a Bull Taco just from looking at it from right here. 69, he was very fast earlier. He's from Sewell, New Jersey. That's Robert Smith. He's doing for Metro Racing and Moto Gear on that 69 bike.
Like I said before, it's so interesting to see the year gap on some of the bikes out there.
Yeah, you know, modern equipment, vintage equipment. So looks like they're still having problems lining some of these riders up. Still lining up. Clements back there on the Speed Merchant jersey, getting his big, big iron lined up. Ezra Bruski right there on the 07.
I think they're getting ready. Everyone's shaking their heads.
Yep, here we go. Main event time, amateur main event, the 911 way at the back of the pack. Keep your eyes on him. He won the semi. Here we go. 22 gets a good hole shot. That's Myman. Oh, 1-2. Oh. Riders going down. 3-4. There's people everywhere.
Uh-oh, they're going to come into this.
There's a red flag. Red flag. Oh. They'll shut them down. They were all around the racetrack. I think that's the 06. I don't have the 06 on my list, but I think that's the one Diana was talking about that won the semi earlier, too.
Everyone looks to be safe. Everyone's getting up, walking away. But it was just too much carnage in turn one for the race to keep going.
All right, so the 06 is Laurel Crack, I believe. That's the one that won the semi two earlier. So one of the riders going down. Here's a look at the replay right here on the screen. It starts about the 90 loses the front end. That's not even where the wreck is. So it happens a little bit further back. There it goes one high side. He catches another. His bike catches up to the bike in front of his, the 44 of Bush. He's actually our pole setter. So, man, Bush, it just started way back in the pack, and that's a domino effect right there. Man, it went forward all the way around the corner.
Yep, that was a crazy one.
Good thing is they all got up. They're all trying to restart their motors, and they're all going to line back up. The crowd's putting their hands together down here.
I think I saw someone out there with a sweatshirt with Diana on the front of it. They're out there racing with a hoodie with Diana on the hoodie.
Does she have a lapel microphone to jump on a motorcycle? Man, that's pretty sneaky.
Yeah, guys, you know, I do make my own sweatshirts. They do have great images of me on the front, and you're right. There is a guy out here racing with me on his shirt. So I might have to go into the business of making jerseys.
There you go.
Here we go. Restart. Light turns green. They're off. This time it's a little bit smoother through the first corner. 44's got the lead. That is Bush. 44 machine out in front. Looking pretty smooth out in front.
Oh, I thought it was going to be a clean race, but we already have a rider down.
Oh, it's not going to be clean. Open amateur class on a tight indoor race like this? No way.
Where did that rider go? Is he already off the track?
The 911's already off the track. Everybody else still going at it. Uh-oh. 44 is getting some lap traffic, goes around the 08 machine.
Is the 44 in the lead right now?
44 is still in the lead. That's Bush. He was the pole setter. He's got company coming. The 22 is right behind him. That's Myman. Myman was up there in the lead when we had our first restart. They're bumping and banging a little bit throughout the pack. There's racing going on all the way around. Man, 44 is getting in the corners really hard. That's the 44 bike. Two laps to go for your leader on the Honda. Robert Bush, I believe, on the 44 machine.
The 32 is a smooth race right behind him as well, though.
Jackie Mitchell out there on that Bolt Taco. Laps are winding down. He caught up some lap traffic. Wide flag. Now we'll be looking for the checker flag.
There it is.
Double checker flag coming out. I think 44 is your winner. Spotlight's on the 44 bike. Open amateur class, 44, trying to make sure his first name. I believe that's Robert Bush out here. We'll make sure when we get down there and talk to the winner here in just a second. That was the open amateur class. Man, it was a stacked main event for sure. The only one rider gets to go up there and meet up with Diana Dahlgren, and we'll check out with the winner here in just a second. Let's go down the track side right now with our winner.
The winner, Open Am 44, Robert Bush. Congratulations. Coming in so hot, you almost ran me over. You can't deny the emotion here tonight.
Yeah, no, I'm having a blast. Thanks to everybody, all my friends helping out. Harley, the Mama Tried crew, Deus Ex Machina, Rebel Leatherworks, O'Neill Racing, and Big Jim Wood in Southland, baby.
All right, give a big round of applause to number 44, Robert Bush, taking the win for Open Am.
Thank you, Jim Wood from out there, California. There he is, getting some love from a Rusty Butcher right there. Let's take a look at some of the starts and the 911 crash here. Look at this replay coming right at the camera. Lost the front wheel, goes for a nice slide. Look at that bike, does some dancing right there. Whoa!
It hurts my heart to see that bike flying around.
Yeah, here's a look at the finished double checker flag right there for the 44 bike. 22 got second, still put on the back wheel. Jackie Mitchell on the 32, Bull Taco finishes in the third spot. Up next, our open vintage final. They give them two laps to warm up and clear off their tires. It's time for our vintage riders coming out for their vintage main event. Diana down there, are you ready for this one?
Yes, guys, the engine size is unlimited. Riders must be 18 years of age at this event. Engines must be a model year 1981 or earlier, and the rear brakes are mandatory.
Mandatory, I like it. They're pulling them up. 52 is Mischler, 45 Flaherty. That's JJ, 69 Smith, 64 Charlie Roberts, 60 is Murray, 34 Jeremy DeRider, 88 Nagelkirk, 538 Fisher, 37 Dom Baugh, 431 Darren Carter, also on a Bull Taco, the 11 Jungroth, and the 50 is Skipworth. Here we go. The rider on the outside used to be national number 34. Charlie Roberts used to be national number 64 right there in the middle. And keep your eyes on the 45. That's the X Games gold medal winner, right? In the hooligan class.
That's right.
That's
JJ.
Correct, right?
I don't know if they got medals that last year, but
I hope so. Dude, I hope
so. He still won.
He still won at X Games. Here we go. Light turns green. The front wheels come up as the clutches come out. Whoa. 45, your leader. That's bad news for everybody else. A lot of people stuck deep in the traffic. Yo, one to ride her down. They're still running out front. 44, Flaherty. 88 has no tail section. The tail section's coming off the bike. 60 bikes right there in hot pursuit. That's Murray.
Flaherty knows what it feels like to win. I think he can hold on to this.
I think so, too. I believe you're right.
JJ's a local to here, so he got to probably stay in his own bed.
Probably so, and he, man, he's feeling good. You can just tell by watching him ride out there. That's Eric Mitchell on the 52 bike. They're catching in some lap traffic.
Yep.
Everybody spread out all the way around the track. The leader in turn number two, now going down the back straightaway, not even picking up his left foot. He's being real calm, real conservative, and just trying to keep that low line and block everybody else. He's going around the 69 bike, or he's trying to. 69 was really fast earlier today. He actually qualified fourth. He's struggling right now to keep the leader away from him. Now the leader's getting into the 530. Oh, 60 goes down. That's second place going down.
No way.
Yeah, now that, I believe, the 431 of Darren Carter moves into second unofficially.
JJ's just been pulling away on this one.
Yeah, absolutely. He looks really smooth out there. He's actually caught up to the back of Charlie Roberts in the 34 of Jeremy DeRuyter. Last lap. Checkered flag out. 45. He's got the Fuel Cafe on the front of his leathers, and dude, he is just as excited as he is as he's ever been right now.
Did he qualify for the hooligan class? Do we see him on the list?
I'm pretty sure. Man, we'll take a look at the replay of the crash from early on, right off the start. JJ got a good hole shot. The 52 gets into the back tire of the second spot. Man, he got tight right there. He ran into the back tire of the rider in front of him, and then it was just chaos from there on out. But, man, that was a tight one right there. That was our vintage final. Let's go down to our vintage winner and Diana Dahlgren.
The number 45, JJ Flaherty, bringing home the win. Whole shot dominating the entire time and then crossing that checkered flag. Who would you like to thank here?
Oh, man. Well, first, Scott Johnson. This is his bike. This is my first time racing this, and I don't think it could have went any better. But thanks for Milwaukee Harley, WFO Racing, Blue Moon Customs, Soulfine Customs. Thanks, everyone. Anyone that's here.
First time winning his Flat Out Friday. Guys, back to you.
Sounds good. Up next, our youth final. Here comes the little guys coming to the track. And we got some fast, young, up-and-coming riders. 67, that's Vince Young. 72, Trevor Tidwell. 31P is Benoist. 97, Kalise. 14 is Haas. 18, that's Trevor Tidwell. There's two Tidwells in this one. I have to check on who's who. They're both starting with T. The 80 is Garvin, and the 618 is Reese.
Now, do you think when this youth class is out there right now, are they looking at the pros or are they looking at the hooligans? And which one are they wanting? Which class are they wanting to be in?
You know, as an up-and-comer kid, you think the pros, but the hooligan class is so big and so popular right now, maybe they want to be on a Harley.
Yep.
You know, I don't know. It's hard to say. So to correct the Tidwell situation, Trevor Tidwell is on, let's see, Trevor Tidwell is on the number 18. Tyler will be on the other one. So Trevor is on this one. So that means
Tyler's on the 72.
Tyler's on 72, man. A little confusing when the brothers get out there and race.
And are they both on Cowies?
Yep.
No, one's on a KTM,
right.
One's on a Cowie.
The 65 is the KTM. They're cleaning up, still cleaning up from the race before the 618 bike. Actually, the 618 bike having trouble getting his bike started. That's one of the riders that's supposed to be out there. That is Reese on the 618. Out here in this youth class. Crowd's going crazy all behind us up here. That's Andrew Reese from Bellevue, Illinois. Most of these riders from Wisconsin. There's a couple Illinois riders in this one. Reese gets the bike fired up. Dad said thank you very much. Hand it over. You better hurry up. You better hurry up. They're getting ready to start without you. Start racing when you're on a 65, or
I started racing on a 50, and then, but yes, I didn't race 65s. I raced 60s.
They didn't have 65s back then.
I'm not that old.
I was just throwing that out there. I'm just saying,
taking me feel old, man.
It's a big change, you know. I'm used to saying 60s and 80s. Now there's 65s and 85s, and we got a combination of both out there here in our youth final. Here we go. Oh, man, there's some creeping going on. The light turns green, though. 72 with the lead. That's Tyler Tidwell. I've been talking about both the Tidwell kids for a while at the Dirt Track Grand Championship, and they're both really fast. Out in front, 72, Tyler leading the pack on the Kawasaki.
And look at Tyler. He's even looking way ahead in the corner. Yeah, he's looking
far. I like that a lot. I like how they're doing that a lot. They're teaching that more and more in the flat track racing schools now. You look ahead. If you look right in front of you, that's where you're focusing on. 67 in second. That's actually Vince Jung. J-U-N-G is his last name. He was our fast qualifier, but he's in second place. He's got that motorcycle revved up right now. It's a Honda. He's actually caught the leader. Catching him is one thing. Passing him is another thing.
Notice every bike out there is a two-stroke.
Absolutely.
Those are becoming more and more rare, but a lot of the youth is still on them.
Absolutely. I like it. That 67's riding the high line. He's going around the outside. 67 looking for the lead. They're just past the halfway point, so it's going to be between the 67 and the 72. They were in two separate heat races earlier today, so now they're putting the best against each other here in this main event. Tyler on the 72, Vince on the 67 bike. Vince had a little trouble in that last corner.
Are we going to see a pass?
I don't know. There's two laps to go. 67's going to have to find a way around. What I like is he's not following the leader. He's looking for a new way around. Hey, they're catching some lap traffic. This could be a factor. White flag is out. The leader got by smoothly. I think this one's going to be all the 72 bike from here on out.
72 guarded that inside real nice the whole race.
Nice move right there. 72 with the double checkered flag. That is Tyler Tidwell out there racing with his brother and everybody else out there in that amateur youth final. He gets to talk to Diana Dahlgren here in just a second, but how cool is that? He just went right on by. Maybe he's got a girlfriend. He don't want to stop over there and talk to her.
No, he's coming around for the second time. Oh, there it is.
All right. He took to his victory lap. Let's look at the replay. There's a 67 try in the high line right there. That's Jung on the 67. I like it because he was looking for a new way around. Wasn't able to make the pass right there. Came up just a little bit short, but it's still a solid ride out there. And 72 taking the winner. Let's go down trackside. Tyler Tidwell and Diana Dahlgren.
The number 72, Tyler Tidwell, getting the whole shot, dominating that entire race. How was your race, and who would you like to thank for bringing you out here tonight?
The race was great, and I want to thank my mom, dad, Country Saloon, Raymond Cross, Darren Carter, and everyone else.
All right, congratulations, Tyler Tidwell, taking the W here.
Looks like he got that interview down pretty good, too. He nailed it. He thanked all of his sponsors, and he knows what it's all about.
Mom and dad first.
Yeah, mom and dad, and then the Country Saloon down there in Peoria, Illinois, you know. It's cool they sponsor a lot of racers and up-and-comers and some of the pro guys. So now we're moving to one of the exciting classes. This is the women's class.
Now, one of these girls I actually saw in the open class, I think.
Yeah, the 08, Zaria Martin. She won here last year. 67 is pro. 158, Annie Wyman. 144 is Dahl. 48 is Lee. 74 is Cromie. 17L is Orloff. 558, Poland. The 11, that's Bree Poland. We talked about her earlier. The 11 is Lang. And the 06, let me find the 06. I don't have a name on my list. I'll try to figure it out for you here in just a second. But, man, this is the women's class. Are you excited about this one?
I am excited. It was Martins that was in just the open class, right?
Yeah, it was Zaria.
So do you think that's going to help her?
Yeah, absolutely, because she got to check out the track. She knows what it feels like right now. The track will go through several changes as the Dr. Pepper Syrup works into the track. I saw some of the pro riders actually sneaking out there earlier, too. They go out there and they kick the ground. They want to feel how sticky it is. So I definitely think it will help the Zaria Martins, who was just out there in the amateur class. Wyman's out there in the 158. The 558, Bree Poland, I talked about her earlier, but she used to own a road race team, and somebody challenged her last year here. They said, if I built you a bike, would you ride it? Would you race it at Mama Try It? And she said, yep, and she's out here.
Can't turn that down.
Hell no. I want to race out here too, man. Let's get us a bike.
Martins is out front right now, and she's the one that was out there already racing.
Yep, Zaria. Oh, she's got the motocross style. She sticks her left foot way out in front like you do when you ride your motocross bike.
That's right. She was using it. Check this out.
Most flat trackers keep that left foot right beside you, but she's got it way out front, which puts the weight on the front wheel. So it might be a good smart move out here on the concrete, you know? Might help her out a little bit. Zaria won out here last year on the 08 machine. She's looking really strong here so far as we're clicking through our main events. This is the women's main event.
Second place isn't falling too far behind, though.
Annie Wyman keeping up with her. She's actually in her sights now, so it's a battle in the women's class. 08 has the lead. Can she hang on to it? Annie Wyman, 158, sneaking up on the back tire. Now they're getting into some lap traffic as they go around the 67 bike. Look how low that rear tire is on the 08. It's working for her, though. Zaria Martins has the lead, but she's in some lap traffic. It could be a factor for the win. What do you think?
Uh-oh.
They're holding her up a little bit.
They are holding her up.
Kevin Clark.
The gap is tightening quite a bit.
Absolutely. And he's got the inside now. Here she comes off the corner. She just didn't get off the corner just as hard as... Oh, that was a good move right there. Zaria stuck the front wheel in there. Let the lap rider know, hey, I'm right here. Lap rider moves out of the way. That was a great job by both of those young ladies. Here comes the 158. Looking for a way around. Last lap. Double checkered flag. Zaria Martins goes back-to-back wins out here in Milwaukee. She won here last year.
Went out first and led every lap.
Let's take a look at the finish here in just a second. It was really tight coming to the very end. She had some wheel hop. She goes up underneath the lap rider, and she got on the throttle. I don't even know if she knew that second place was right there so close. But, man, second place caught up at the very end, and there's somebody happy down there at the victory podium. Let's go down to our winner, and Diana Dahlgren.
Zaria Martins, 08, taking the win here in the women's class. Tell us how you did it, girlfriend.
I don't know. I just went for it. Got a good start. Kept my line. I would like to thank my grandma and grandpa and my parents.
All right. Well, congratulations. Give another big round of applause and hit that like button if you're liking 08 Zaria Martins taking the win here.
That's right. I love to see how family oriented this whole sport is. And it was that way for myself, and to see her, you know, say thank you, grandma, grandpa, mom and dad.
Yep. That's what it's all about right now. That's how they got here, and that's how they, they keep going week in, week out. You know, they're at the amateur level still. They're racing for trophies, so it's an expensive sport sometimes, and it's always good to have family behind you, and I love it when they thank their folks and their grandparents right away. Now check this out. Here comes the Boonie Final. Woo! This is the class you're supposed to be racing in.
Yeah, can you take care of this for me? I'm going to run down there real quick.
Hop over this glass wall and head on down there. It's the Boonies. Number 20 is Klinzig. 35 is Kilkenny. 45, Wittig, 24, Paulson, 101, Flaherty, 90 is Peterson, 257, Bettis, 777, Mascari, 699 is Maldonado, 81 is Kitterhagen, 69 plus 1 is Feber, 62 K is Kraft, Brown on the 3, and Fryer on the 73. Diana, tell us about this class.
Yeah, these bikes have a pull start. Their wheels are no bigger than 12 inches, and their rigid rear wheel, the left tag is foldable or removed. And remember, these riders have to wear full AMA required racing safety gear, including gloves, long sleeve shirt, and a full face helmet on, and they must be 18 years of age.
So that's the rules of the Boonie class. We had 29 of them at the start. We've narrowed it down to the fastest 12. There's two rows of six, and here we go. They must have a pull start. Look at that. Look who's in the very middle of the pack. JJ Rides.
Think he's going to take it?
I don't know, man. There's some fast guys out there. Kilkenny's out there on the 35 bike. The fast qualifier is the 20 of Klinzig. Man, there he is. He don't need no gloves. He's got Boonie bike on his shirt.
This is his racing right here.
That's his racing wear?
Yeah.
All right. Well, here we go. Supposed to have gloves on, but.
Not in the Boonie class.
Well, all right. Diana reads the rules. Look at that. JJ got a heck of a drive. He's actually pushing with his feet and got out front. In a hurry. They're all the way around the racetrack already. Lap one in the books. It's the JJ Flaherty 101 on the number plate out in front.
This whole race reminds me of some funny dream I've had.
Maybe you're dreaming right now. Look at that. His 101 numbers are glittery and everything. That's fun. That's like a Briggs & Stratton motor, isn't it?
I think they all are.
What sounds like.
I mean, hey, guys, do you remember JJ won a race earlier? So is he going to be our first two-time champ of the night? He'll probably become the only two-time champ of the night.
Yeah, I think he can actually go for three, can't he? Later on in the hooligan class, too. So he might win three main events out here. We have 11 classes. So JJ Rides is out front pulling away. It's JJ Flaherty, number 101, your leader. And he's stretching out the pack right now. He is pulling away as the bikes are all the way around the racetrack. 35 coming up the inside. That's Kilkenny. I believe we got a new leader. I think it's 35.
No.
Really?
Uh-oh.
Look at that. Look how fast he's going. I think it's 35.
He took off on him.
Yeah, I think 35's the leader.
You think JJ's getting tired from all that racing tonight? You think he's going to be affected in the hooligan class?
I don't know. Is that or Kilkenny found something? I don't know. We'll wait to see who Kevin Clark gives the flag to, but, oh, he lost fire in the 82 bike trying to full start
full
again.
Start that thing.
White
like a
flag
dang lawnmower.
Is out. White flag is out. 35 is the leader, I believe. Here comes the checkered flag. So Kilkenny pulls out the upset right there.
He took it. Both of them are sponsored by Fuel Cafe.
Yep. I think that's one of the guys that rode his mini bike off the bar last night at Fuel Cafe. We had a little mini bike race in the bar last night.
Why wasn't I invited?
I'm not invited to the later on one, so we'll just have to talk about this later. Kilkenny takes the win right there. That's the 35 of Kilkenny. He is the winner. Let's go down with our winner in Diana.
That's right. He passed the 101 of J.J. Flaherty, the number 35, Kilkenny. Congratulations. Who would you like to thank here tonight?
Thank you. It's all Team Yuck. Tom and John built this beautiful bike, and they just let me trash it.
All right. Well, congratulations. Give a big round of applause and thumbs up to the number 35, Kilkenny.
So here's the pass that I missed. I think you saw it, or did you see this?
I just saw how fast the 35 was going. Look how far back he was going into the corner, but he set him up. JJ goes wide, the 35 comes up the inside, and he was gone. From there, he was just gone.
It's almost like JJ didn't even know he was there.
I don't think so. I think JJ thought he had it. He was out there on cruise control.
Yep.
All right, check it out. Look what's coming to the track. I thought this was the classier ride.
Some of them are pedaling.
The mopeds. All right, it's time for the moped final, and they're coming out right now. We got a whole bunch of them in this one. 12 entries and 12 of them will all make the main event. Diana, tell us about this class.
Well, these riders must be 18 years or older, no larger than a 70cc engine, stock muffler, rubber pedals, no turn signals, mirrors, or passenger pegs.
So I guess you can't take yours out there because your moped has buddy pegs.
Yeah, it does have buddy pegs.
Oh, so that's why you're not out there?
Yep.
Okay, I got you. The 7 of Collada, the 1 of Schwanker, the 5 of Go, the 0 of Augustine, 115 is Aish, 345 is Raider, 310 of Steel, 95 is Mock, 69 is Pradley, 68 Motzing, 88 is also a Motzing, the number 2 is Fro, and the 56 of Hoos. So, man, this is the moped class. This one's going to be exciting. There's going to be 12 of them out there.
Yeah, this is the moped class, but I'm just more curious of which one of you guys want to go on a ride with me on one of these bad boys after the races.
I volunteer Lance.
Yes, let's do this.
Yeah, that's right. Lance and I, we're going to go on a hot date here after these races on one of these bad mopeds. Maybe the one with the cardboard front plate.
Maybe you guys can go to the after party together. That'd be cute.
Show up on one of these mopeds, pedaling
We're actually going to ride the moped through the after party.
That's right.
We are the after party.
All right, I'll be the cameraman. And I'll commentate it as you guys do that, okay?
It seems like you're the one with the gasoline just pouring it all over us right now.
Yeah, I'm
getting us all fired up.
I'm getting y'all at it. Yeah, let's do it. I don't care which one it is. Oh, they got takeoff running. Some of them are pedaling. Here we go. The moped final.
I see more pedaling than throttling right now.
Look at the leader. Leader's got some long hair flowing out the back helmet. So does second place. I wonder if this is their daily commuters. 7, Collada. Oh, look, he's picking up his left foot. 7 in front, 5's in the 2 spot. 5 is, last name is Go. 7 is on a, that's Collada. Is that a Pugo?
I'm not sure what these are.
It's listed as a PUC. I don't know. I'm just saying. Looks like a lot of fun.
Homemade.
7 in the lead. 5 right there in second. 5's going to look for a way through.
This is a class that I want to be racing in as well.
Man, you're gonna race every class.
All the goofy ones.
Okay. Puke. P-U-C-H. That's what it says on the gas tank.
Oh, pooch. I've
pooch, heard of there that. You go. Yeah. Puke. I don't know. Puke.
I've heard of those before.
Fuck. I don't know. Here we go. Battle for the lead. 7 and the 5 going at it. They're holding the handlebar to handlebar for just a second. 7 goes back out in front. That's Collada. Twisting the throttle. He doesn't have any gloves on either. Oh, watch out. Oh, the leader just about goes down. 5's right there in hot pursuit. These guys go just as many laps as everybody else. 10-lap final.
These gas tanks hold enough?
I don't know. Good thing they got pedals. 2 laps to go. Brian Smith, our 2016 AFT Grand National Champion, just sent me a text message. He's having a good time watching this class right now. White flag is out here in the moped class. With 7 in the lead. Collada showing the way. Last lap, double checkered flag. 7 taking the win. Pulling the wheelie on the back straightaway. I wonder if he's got proper fuel in there. Let's take a look at the replay. how he lost the lead. Seven goes to the high side. Five looks up the inside. A little bumping, a little banging. Oh. Here they come. Five had the lead. They split one lap rider down the back straightaway. So five, look how high his seat is on the five machine.
One thing I noticed is the last couple passes were all because of a
lap rider
in the
yep.
middle.
And that's because it's a 16th mile and it's really tight. Let's go down and hear from tonight's winner in the moped class.
Nick Kaladin, the number seven, taking the win here in the moped. I mean, I actually really want your bike, but we actually want to know who you want to thank for bringing you out here tonight.
I want to thank Baby Jesus and Dale Earnhardt Jr.
That's right. Give it up. That's a mic drop right there.
Boom. Love it. Well, this is what I've been waiting for all night long. Lance, it's time for our expert finals, the fastest 12 pros that has showed up. 24 experts made the trip up here, and that is Jack Kane's going to bring out that beautiful XR750 to lead him out to the main.
Yeah, this is going to be an incredible race, that's for sure.
Absolutely. So Jack is out there riding Charlotte's motorcycle. That's Charlotte Kane's, who passed away back in 2016, and he led the field out on the XR715. It's time for the XR750, I should say. It's time for our expert final on the pole, number 37. That's Bronson Bauman. 222, Jeremy Orr from Pennsylvania. 27, Robbie Pearson. 35L, Jake Mattia on Charlotte Cage's motorcycle. 62, Dan Bromley. 65, Corey Texter. 69 is Morgan Mitchler. Number 7, that's Oliver Brindley from England. 88, Ron Wood. 29K is Kyle Weiss. 22, James Monaco. And the 161, Hurricane Matthew Gunther.
These are the pros. They are not scared to go fast. They are not scared to bang bars. They are not scared to do what it takes to win.
We just noticed there's people from Oslo, Norway, watching us on Facebook Live. We love it. We love everybody that's tuning in, including Brian Smith, the 2016 Grand National Champion. He's tuned in just in time for our expert main event. This one is 35 laps, ladies and gentlemen. $100 to lead every lap. We will see who's going to take home the big bucks here tonight. Expert final. Will it be 37, Bronson Bauman? Corey Texter actually led most of the race last year, but was docked because he jumped the start, so he finished up in the fifth spot. They're going to give him one lap to check out the racetrack. Dan Bromley, the tall drink of water from Pennsylvania on the 62. 35L, Jake Mattia. 27, Robbie Pearson. 222, Jeremy Orr. 37 is Bronson Bauman. Dude, I can't sit down for this one. This is what I love right here. Some of the best flat trackers in the world. They're giving them a couple of laps to warm up their tires. So what they're doing, they're cleaning out their tires. They're putting some heat in there because they're going to go 35 laps. They don't want to blister their tires early, so they give them just a few more laps to warm them up, and it's going to be on here real quickly. So some of the best riders in the country, and like I said, Oliver Brindley's all the way here from Doncaster, England on the 07 bike. He borrowed a motorcycle for tonight's event. Crowd favorites, probably the 35L. That's Jake Mattia. He's normally national number 29. He's riding Charlotte Kane's own 450. Jack keeps that bike maintained for you. Got Bugs Pearson on the 27. Jeremy Orr, the 222. Corey Texter on the outside. He was docked and had to be finished the first rider one lap down last year for jumping the start. Here we go. Expert final.
And they're up.
Bronson gets the whole shot on the inside. One rider goes really wide. It's Bauman in the lead. Battle is for everybody else. Back on through the pack. Bronson Bauman with the whole shot, showing the way. Bronson looking pretty smooth. Jeremy Orr in second. Jake Mattia in third. Remember, 35 laps. You've got to stick. You got to keep the leader in your sights, I believe.
And don't forget, every time you go through that finish line,
$100 bill. Absolutely. I actually donated $100 last year for lap number 23. I didn't get it in time this year. They had already filled up.
No way.
Yeah, dude. Bronson Bauman out front showing the way. He's from Illinois, originally from Salinas, California. Here comes Mattia looking for second place. Mattia takes over the number two spot. 35L moves into second right now. So out in front, your leader is still the 37 right. That's national number 37, Bronson Bauman. Look how low his rear tire is. He's getting as much traction as possible. Now Mattia's in second. Third is Orr. Can Jake Mattia catch the leader? He felt pretty confident. I talked to him last night. He said he came up short last year because he didn't even take off on the first lap because he saw somebody jump. He worked his way up to a second place last year. He's second place right now, but he's right behind the leader.
It's incredible. Look how fast they're going. They're leaned over the whole track. I mean, they're never even standing the bike up.
Battle for the lead into turn number one. It's Bronson Bauman, and right there is Jake Mattia, the 35L. He has to know that's the leader. He's passed everybody else. He's caught the leader right now. The leader is 37, second 35L. There they are on our screen. Bronson Bauman, Jake Mattia. Mattia on the 35L bike. Morgan Mishler's on the 69 bike. Here comes Mattia. Mattia looks up the inside. Battle for the lead. He shuts the door. Nice move right there. Bronson Bauman shut the door on Jake Mattia. Bauman lives in Illinois, originally from California. He rode his ride in San Francisco. Then they moved to a San Jose indoor. He's raced concrete a lot. He's got some experience. Mattia's got the bike. He's on Charlotte Cage's motorcycle right now. Halfway, flags are in the air.
30. Can he do it? Can he do it?
I think so. He's close enough right now. He knows that's the leader. Remember, the last two races, we've seen a lot of leaders having trouble with lap riders. It's going to be a factor here in just about one or two more laps.
Yep.
They're catching a bunch of riders. They got around Gunther. Now they're catching up to the 07. That is the
Bowman.
Rider from England.
Can Bowman deal with the pressure?
Bauman on the 37 bike. He is right now. He's actually laying it way over. Here comes Mattia once again. Mattia to the lead.
Got it.
Jake Mattia goes to the lead. The crowd is on their feet behind us. Mattia, your new leader, 35L. Second 37, Bronson Bauman. He knows he's only been passed once tonight, and that was just a lap or two ago.
Yep.
Can he catch back up?
I don't know.
Watch the lap riders, though.
Looks like Matoya's pulling away a little bit.
You commented on it the last few races. The lap riders were factors for sure. Now Mattia, he has to work it. Oh, he got around Bromley. A new rider goes down.
Rider down, rider
Bronson,
down.
Bronson Bauman goes down. That was second place. I don't know who's in second anymore. Right now, we know Mattia's in the lead. He's down the back straightaway. He's now into turn number three on the 35L. That's your leader. He's got to work his way through the traffic. Now he's caught up to Corey Texter. Corey, I thought, would be battling for the lead. Now he's up to the back tire of the 27 of Robbie Pearson. Mattia's trying to work his way through the traffic. Mattia has an issue. He's still in the lead, though. That's all right. That's all right. He's got some breathing room. Yep. Nobody's right behind him. Actually, Dan Bromley is now. He's a lap down. What a race we have. Five laps to go. Kevin Clark shows him five laps around the 16th mile oval here in Milwaukee. It's Mattia out in front. He's got to get by this lap rider of Bugs Pearson. Look at the crisscrossing in front of him. Still Mattia. Less than four laps, probably three laps to go. Mattia still in control of this one. Mattia goes down. The leader goes down.
Who's in the lead now?
It's got to be the 37 bike. I'm not sure.
Was that 27 of Pearson?
No, he was lapping Pearson. I think it's white flag is out. I think it's the 37 bike. He fell off earlier too. Checkered flag. We'll see who gets the checkered flag. 37? Here they come. I have no idea. I honestly have no idea.
Well, I'm hoping the winner can roll up to Diana and we'll know.
Dude, what a tough break. First off for Bronson Bauman, he fell off. He's congratulating people on the back straightaway. Now they think it's the 29 bike of Kyle Weiss. I'm not even sure if anybody knows right now. I'm not a scorekeeper.
I'm thinking three guys are all leaving with a couple hundred dollars tonight.
Well,
that's for sure.
Yeah, 37. He fell off and still comes back and wins the main event. Bronson, they call him Brombo. Brombo is going to be, this is going to be one heck of an interview right here. He is so excited right now. He's so excited. Bronson Bauman, one heck of a rider. Here's a look at the replay. This is the 35 and the 37. The 37 goes in low sides and spins out right here.
But he didn't give up.
No, he keeps the bike running. He hops up as fast as he can. He sees out the carpet on the bottom, jumps back on the saddle and takes off.
Lost no time.
And that was good enough to keep in the second spot. And then Mattia throws it away right here. This is your leader for a while, 35L Jake Mattia on Charlotte Canes' bike. He gets underneath Robbie Pearson.
Black traffic.
We've been talking about that. He hits the back of Pearson. And our winner, Bronson Bauman's down there with Diana Dahlgren.
That's right, you guys heard it. Capitalizing on a falling, taking the W here. Who would you like to thank at Flat Out Friday?
Definitely, I gotta thank my Glenn's Auto Body Honda 450. This thing is working like a dream out here. Bill Warner Racing, Drew Moss of Fly Racing, Orion Helmets, Vaughn Zipper Goggles, even though I'm not wearing any. I got to thank you for being here. My girlfriend, she's awesome. Her entire family, my mom and dad and my grandma. You know, there's so many people that support us and let us come out here and have fun. And all the fans, I mean, you guys are right. Bring it on.
Congratulations to number 37. Big round of applause and some thumbs up on all of our feeds. He's very excited about that W. Guys, take it away.
It's not very often you fall off in flat track and still pull off a victory.
Especially on this small of a track.
Man, he got up so fast. That's why you never give up. You fall off, you get back up, you get going as fast as you can. Tough break for Jake Mataya, but now it's time to move on to our hooligan final. We're just about done. We got the hooligans, and we got a secret surprise final coming up after that. So the hooligan final coming up next. We got the fastest 12. This was the biggest class of the night with 54 entries, ladies and gentlemen. These are be the fastest 12 through qualifying here tonight. Getting ready to come out. You ready for this one, Lance?
I'm ready for this. And I mean, it's so sad to see some of the familiar faces out on the sidelines right now, rooting on their friends, but not in the main event.
They're going to be some of the biggest cheerleaders, you know, bigger than us down there. They're going to be cheering them on. So the pits are full. We're just about done out here at Flat Out Fridays. And then Mama Tried Motorcycle Show is happening tomorrow afternoon. And this is about to go down. The hooligans coming to the track. 963 is Hill. 911 is Clement. 42 is Heverly. 35X Jake Bender. 25 is Rick Ginther from Illinois. 73 is Bush. 44X Dan Jacobson. 45X Benny Carlson. 35 is Kilkenny. 45 is Flaherty in his third class. 72 is Jordan Baber. And the 85, that is Suttle, who won the semifinal just a little while ago.
Now, JJ's already won a race tonight.
Yep. Second in the main event. He's been out there recently. I think that's a big advantage for him.
Mikey Virus is looking real fast out there in qualifying. He's got the number one pole.
Yep. So Jake Bender, the 35X, he was a Grand National tuner last year for Corey Texter. He said, I'll give up those duties. He's racing a couple different classes. He's on 35X because Kilkenny is running the number 35 here tonight. So Bender's
so
right there on the front
row.
Who's
your money on?
Man, I don't know. Hill's fast. I would like to see Bender win. I don't know if he's got it for these guys. These are big, heavy machines. You know, 10 laps around this really tight racetrack. I'm not sure. Who's your money on?
Can I go half and half? Can I say Mikey Virus of Rusty Butcher? And okay. Can I say JJ?
Do I get the rest of the field, or what do you want to do?
All right, I'm going Virus.
All right, I'm going to go with my boy. Jake Bender racing on the 35 bike. I'd like to see him win. Actually, my money, I'd like to see Kilkenny win, but he's starting on the back row, so he's got his work cut out for him. Also back there is Jordan Baber. He's a good very good rider. There's the 67 bike. I don't have him on my list. Do you have him on one of your lists?
Maybe I don't, but it looks like he's not sure if he should be out there or not.
I don't think he is. Yeah, he's not on my list. He didn't make the main. Now he's trying to slide on up there. We're going to go without
race
him.
Race holding up. No, they're holding the race for him.
Well, what is he doing? I don't think he made the main event.
They're not sure either.
Well, he's not on my list. That's why we're not the officials, though.
That is right.
You know who the head official is?
Who's that?
Burke Sumner.
Burke
Sumner is right here beside us.
Oh.
His brother, former National 45 Jim Sumner, a fellow racer.
Nice.
Yep. Burt has all of the history of Grand National Flat Track. Most of it's in his head, a lot of it's in his book, and on his website. Here we go, lights turn green. Oh! Stacking him up! There goes my guy. My guy's out, he's in next to last. 42's in the lead.
My guys hold the second position right now.
Heverly's in the lead.
And I've already seen Mikey pick somebody up.
Oh, there goes something flying off that motorcycle. Maybe we'll catch that later on.
He's just shedding weight, my
friend. Yard sale. I think it was his left foot peg. Something went flying.
Hey, you don't need that.
No, you don't need your left foot peg. 45, Benny Carlson's worked his way up to the third spot. Leaders the 42 bike of Heverly. Heverly still in the lead.
Come on, Mikey. Don't make me look bad.
Oh, there goes another foot peg. Just fell off in turn number two right in the middle of the groove. Man, there's action all over the place. Oh, where goes Bender? Bender went to go check. He wanted to get some camera time over there. 42 still in the lead, trying to hang on to it.
Come on, Mikey. We want to see some bar banging.
Well, which Mikey you cheered for? 963?
963.
All right.
Oh, are they both Mikeys?
Mikey Hill. Heverly's a 40. Okay. All right, just making sure. Oh, 42 had some problems coming off that corner. There's the 963 on the back tire. Carlson's right there in the third spot. Two laps to go. So you're cheering for second place.
Yep.
Out front, 42 of Heberle. Benny Carlson's right there on the 45 bike on the XR1200. White flag is in the air.
Uh-oh.
Last lap, last corner.
Oh!
Double checkered flag comes out. Heberle takes the win. He's already over there against the air fence.
I feel like the hooligans need 35 laps.
That'd be awesome. I think that'd get pretty interesting for sure. So, look, the winner's pretty stoked. He lost his left foot peg early on. There's another foot peg in the middle of the track. It don't matter. Carnage, like you said, they're shedding weight.
Yep.
Big old heavy machines. All right, where'd the winner go? Oh, here he comes. He's still out there showboating a little bit. Let's take a look at the replay. Going into the first corner, look at all of them stacking up. There's my guy, the 35X. He had nowhere to go. Elbow in his nose. Had
good
nowhere
things
to
these
go.
Guys have brakes.
You would think they would know how to use them, but I guess not. They're doing burnouts over here on the other side of the arena, but man, everybody's having some fun. Heverly just about threw it away right there a couple times. And now let's go with tonight's winner, rider number 42. It's Heverle down with Diana Dahlgren.
Standing here with Rich Heverle, taking the whole shot, dominating the entire race, and taking the W. Rich, walk us through that race and let us know who you'd like to thank.
Wow, what a race. Yeah, that was tough. Mikey was on me the whole time, and I saw him. Just had to stay in front of him. But I'd like to thank Brad Woodrick, Bo Woodrick, Ron Wood, my dad, my whole family at home that's watching. Thank you. I love you guys, and I'll see you in a couple days. And say, and I love you, baby Maverick. I have an 8-month-old at home, so.
All right, well, congratulations. Put your hands together. Number 42 winning the hooligan race here. Congratulations, Rich Heverle.
You hear the way he was breathing right there? I don't think he could go 35 laps.
I don't think so. That's a long ways to go. He's looking for his foot peg right now. There's a couple foot pegs flew off. One went into turn one into the wall, and the other one is in turn number two. But
so it wasn't for sale, like you said?
Well, it's a yard sale. He's looking like he's going back to go get it. Maybe somebody else picked it up already. There was one in turn number two. There he goes. Yep, that's my foot peg. Well, what's coming up next is an exciting class.
I'm excited to see what's going to go on in this one.
I have no idea what I'm going to see right now because I've never seen this class before.
They call it the inappropriate class.
Okay.
And I don't even think I need to say any descriptions because I think the name speaks for itself.
Well, I'd like to know a little bit more about it, but they're getting ready to head on out here right now for the last race of the night, ladies and gentlemen. And let's go trackside one more time for our description of this class. Diana Dahlgren.
Hey, guys. Yeah, so these are all things inappropriate. You kind of don't know what to expect in this class. But basically, it looks like we have the donut police. We got a safari, African safari happening down here. We got a couple of stuntmans. Looks like we actually have Captain America and Dr. Seuss. Cat in the Hat. So, and then we also have a couple pink Harleys. I mean, there's just complete debauchery happening in this tunnel, and they're about to come out here and put on a show for us.
Well, we might have a special guest out there coming too. Did you happen to see if there's anything extra special back there?
Yeah, you know, I mean, he was hinting at it. There he is. He just popped up. That's a lowrider. I mean, I think that's a 1967 special snowmobile sled that I see has training wheels on it so that it can roll around this course.
Well, there's a giraffe, I think. And here comes the police officer in shorts. Is this Reno 911?
Yeah, and also we had a pregnant lady with beer attached to her bike.
Oh, perfect.
So we have Larry and Tyser coming out here. He actually fully modified his amazing snowmobile to fit this track. So let's hope that Dr. Pepper Syrup will hook up on these sweet lawnmower tires.
Well, this is going to be crazy. So
I see funky looking bikes. I even see like a proper choppers out there.
Right. Is that an action figure right there at the pole?
That is.
Is that a pregnant lady? Oh, and there's the sled.
Uh-oh.
Is he going to send it?
He's always going to send it.
Of course he is. Is he on our list? I don't even know. Riders are lined up for this one. 27's Birchbach, 707 Larzebeck, 11 is Hickman, 303 is Irby's. 49 is Lutschman, 731 is Langland, 808 Siegel, 0 of Robbins, 9 of Wolf, and the 77 of Dunbar. This is the final race of the night. It is the inappropriate class. And there's also a snowmobile out there at the back of the pack. And I think he's just going to send it. Do you know who that is, right?
It's Larry and Tyson, my friend.
Larry and Tyson. Is that what his name is?
It's Heiser.
It's Heiser.
Not sure if it's his real name.
Well, he's going to send it, that's for sure. Watch out! I think that's a giraffe and a cop getting tangled up in the first corner. Here they come, down the back straightaway. I think that's a Africa Twin Yamaha, if I'm not mistaken. That's a Pacific Coast Honda in the two spot. I know that for sure. There's the snowmobile up there to the fourth.
Why aren't they pulling over for the police officer?
I don't know. Maybe they can't hear the sirens. I don't know. The sled's worked his way up there. He's coming through the pack. Larry and Tyser.
African Safari's out front.
That's a cool looking motorcycle. Oh, here comes a police officer in shorts. Watch out! A little bump and little banging. Here comes the sled. Whoa! There goes the draft. Is that a draft?
He tried to run the pit maneuver on the cop himself.
Yeah, it was. So the police officer's in the lead? Is that what you got? I think so.
Yeah, he's in the lead. He's running full sirens. He's letting everyone know he's out front.
That's a Pacific Coast Honda. That bike's almost all plastic. The full body is all plastic. He's taking off the windshield. That's probably for safety, but he's out there in shorts and knee pads. I like it. He's got some donuts. That's good. See the donuts on his trunk?
Yep.
Yeah. Just in case. I have to make a pit stop. There goes the siren. Just went by us over here. We're on the back straightaway.
Bad boy, what you gonna do?
Bad boy. Donut Squad says on the number plate on the side. I think that's the 707.
Larry needs to take him out right now. He's close enough.
You think so?
Got one. Yeah. I mean, he looked like it, but
I don't know if he knows what place he's in. The snowmobile's all the way up to second place.
Larry should have just been taking people out no matter what.
Double checkered flag. It's going to be the police officer taking the win.
Yeah.
Snowmobile finishing up in second. Larry and Tyser finishes second. Got to check out his videos on YouTube.
Even though Diana's going to get the winner, I'd like him to get Larry for a conversation.
That'd be cool. He wants the checkered flag. Kevin Clark says, no, you just go over there and talk to Diana. Nobody knows where to go. I think they're all confused. Maybe they go to the riders meeting. Oh, there goes the Africa Twin Honda right there. It gets out of the way. That's a good move right there. You know, you don't want to stay down on the ground. Here's the pass for the lead before the rider went down. Up the inside, little bit of contact right there in the donuts, trying to come up the inside. And there goes the battle for the lead. There's when the police officer took the lead on that Pacific Coast Honda.
I mean, look at how the police officer bike doesn't even move. It looks like he's on a seat.
Very consistent. Let's go down to the victory podium for the final time of the night. Diana?
Well, the Donut Police was on patrol tonight, and he was able to collect the win here. Flat Out Friday, inappropriate class. Donut Police, you've taken the win here tonight. Who would you like to thank?
I'd like to thank Phil, who got taken out by me. He can truly say he fought the law, but the law won.
The law won here tonight. That's right, Donut Police taking the win. Congratulations. Completely inappropriate.
Well, that was the inappropriate class. That does wrap up tonight's action out here at Mama Tried Flat Out Friday. Man, we had a great time out here. I hope everybody had a good time watching all around the world. We appreciate everybody tuning in on Facebook, the Harley-Davidson Facebook page. Don't forget there's a motorcycle show is tomorrow. The Mama Tried Motorcycle Show is tomorrow. Special thanks to Diana Dahlgren, Lance Corey right here beside me, the X Games gold medalist. I'm Scotty Dibbler. I had a great time. Lance, you have some fun?
Yeah, I had a blast out there. Just watching everything go down. My favorite thing was the little kids on the little electric bikes and the push bikes and the bicycles.
Man, of course, mine's going to be the expert class. You know, those guys were going for it. Bronson Bowman falls off, still gets back up and collects the win. Tough break for Jake Mattia. All in all, a great night.
You were standing that whole race.
Dude, I cannot sit down.
You were pushing me, standing, hitting me.
I was going for it, too. I had my elbows up. No, I love it. I love it. So, man, what a great night out here. Flat Out Friday. Thanks for letting me. Oh, he does have a donut. The police officer's going to celebrate with the little donut.
Oh, a whole box of them.
Diana, you down there still? I don't know. I think we might have lost her.
No, we actually, I am down here.
Are you having donuts?
I'm hanging out with the donut police right now. I'm super excited. Did you see when he pulled off his helmet, the reaction we got from the crowd?
Yeah, absolutely.
I mean, what was the Facebook likes looking like? Because I feel like it was completely cliche when he took off that helmet and it was just nothing but bearded silliness on his face.
Now he's going to enjoy his donuts. On special behalf of Diana Dahlgren, I appreciate her coming up here. Lance Corey, the X-Am gold medalist up here. I'm Sky Dibbler. I had a great time. Man, so much fun. We got more fun coming up tomorrow at the motorcycle show, the Mama Trot Show. You going?
I can't wait.
I can't wait either. I've never been there. Might as well check it out. Here's some of the highlights from tonight's action. Polished concrete.
What was your favorite moment right here?
Dude, the expert main event had to be. Bronson Bauman taking the win. We had donuts. We had flips. We had crashing. We had all
mopeds.
Kinds of stuff. Mopeds. Inappropriate race. We had snowmobiles. We had crashes. We had winners. We had a lot of fun. Thanks for tuning in on Facebook. We'll catch you next time. I'm Sky Dibbler.
Lance Corey. Thank you,
Diana Dahlgren. See you next time.